Welcome to the Off the Top stream. We are here, boys, and we're here with my boy Kiro Loaded UTV and my boy Kenny Eats. So here we are, y'all. Kenny Bum, as y'all guys know him, man. But listen, we are here today ranking these games, these all-time games. We're going back since before I was born. So we about to start. What games do we start with, bro? Are we just going to start with 07?
I think, you know what? Let's go ahead. Let's knock out all the SmackDown versus Raw games first.
Okay. That's an interesting one. Let's go on ahead and get it done. Okay. I'm going to go on ahead. Loaded, where do you think SmackDown versus Raw 2006 should be at?
Okay.
Who you remember 2006?
That's a better question right now.
I remember mainly 07. Which is the best in the series, so yeah.
Okay, anybody got strong thoughts on 06?
I'm going to be honest, bro. I think I played it, but I don't really remember 06 too much.
I know about it because I made a series for my channel. I played mainly the season mode, and it's kind of follows the trend of like SmackDown versus Raw from 2005, the first one ever, of like, oh, you had this great gameplay, very fast, awesome gameplay, and here comes the pain, and then you completely ruined it, and you slowed it down with the stamina system and everything. It's like 10 times slower feeling, kind of like how we got that in, like, let's say WWE 2K14 to WWE 2K15. It felt immediately slower. That was the problem with these games. The season mode was kind of cool, though, and it still had, like, here comes the pain, you know, DNA left in it a lot. So just based off of that, it was a fun game. And like, if you chose in the season mode Kurt Angle would do the voice acting. You could choose anybody else you wanted and they would do the voice acting. So I thought that was cool. It had some interesting storylines. They might have done motion capture for the cutscenes for the first time ever in that game, and they look so bad. Everybody looks absolutely drunk. But I don't know. It was fun enough that I definitely wouldn't call it a bad game. I would put it at B. I think somewhere in the middle. Okay. Because again, it has
this
that.
This one was on Xbox, wasn't it? Or was this one still when it was on PlayStation?
07 was on. 07 was on Xbox.
I was still playing the bad Xbox.
So let me get this straight, bro. I might have not played 06. 06 was a PlayStation only game at the time.
Yes,
PlayStation 2 exclusive.
Okay, I wasn't aware of that. So I'm gonna keep my opinion then. UTV, you got any opinion on this game?
I feel the exact way that Kero feels. Like, I actually do love that game, but I don't think I love it as much as 07, man. 07, that shit really hit home, especially on Xbox 360. Oh my goodness. Like, the way the graphics look, I'm not like the biggest into graphics, but the graphical leap from the PS2 to the 360, goodness. Like, you just had to be there, bro.
Yeah.
You just had to be there.
Okay, and Kenny, you have any thoughts on this game? Or my fault?
He can't say anything. Oh,
I'm sorry.
He can't say nothing.
Also, I was still playing the bad Xbox games around this time. So yeah, no thoughts on 06 for me. I jumped in on 07 when it finally came to the best console of all time, the Xbox 360. So I'll give my opinions on that. Kiro and UTV, where would y'all put 06?
B for beautiful, man. Trust us. B is good for this game.
I'm like,
right.
I'm in between a B and an A. I guess I'll give it. Guess I'll give it a little bit of love and move it to A. I guess.
So we between an A and a B.
Because it introduced GM mode, so that's a pretty good mode that everybody's been asking to come back before it actually came back. Yeah. So.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Keep it at B for now. I mean, we can come back if we feel change the heart. Say?
Where would y'all put SmackDown versus Raw 2006? Let's see. Let's ask
come
the
on,
chat.
Help us out here, man.
Yeah. Also, I noticed My Life asked us about the Developer Direct. Maybe we can do something about that later.
What is Developer Direct? Can anybody fill me in? Pause.
What up, David Day?
It's just Xbox announcing new things, new games.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Word.
Yeah.
All right. Well, let's just go ahead and slot it. I say, what did you say, UTV?
He said A. So, Carol said B.
But I'm okay with it being at A. And Joseph in chat now says also A. So, let's move it on up there, man.
Let's go ahead and do it, man. All right. So, SmackDown versus Raw 2007. So, I can say pretty confidently that I played this game. And I'm pretty sure this game had, you can, and this was probably in the older games, but since this is the one that I played on 360, this is probably the oldest I went back. This one had the intergender matches, right? You could do men versus women on 07. Yeah. This one had the buried alive match, no?
Yep.
Yes.
Yep. Right, yep. Yeah.
You don't know what's about that one.
Yes. So I'm going to go on ahead, man. I'm going to go on ahead, put 07. I'm probably going to put it in an A tier game because I had a lot of fun with this one. I did go back when I was younger and play this one. Kenny?
You know what? I will definitely agree with you. I will put this at A tier as well because before 07 came out, I was an Xbox guy back then, and I wouldn't play anything else but Xbox games. So I was stuck with, which we'll get to, WWF Raw, WWF Raw 2. We had WrestleMania 21, so it was rough for us. But then we finally got SmackDown versus Raw 2007. The thing I remember about this game the most is putting like your opponent on the ropes and bouncing it up and down, or kicking ahead and just bashing it into the turnbuckle. I had a lot of fun with 07, so I do agree this is an A-tier game.
All right, y'all, hold on. Before we continue on the thoughts, RGT just pointed out something.
Yeah.
That's 08.
Please excuse
is that 08?
Oh, my mistake, but that is indeed 08, man. So listen.
Where is 06?
So
yeah, what?
So is SmackDown versus Raw 06 actually something, though?
They left it off the board?
It is. I think it's not in the...
Wait a minute. SmackDown versus Raw 06 was the one with Vince McMahon on the cover, wasn't
okay,
it?
Okay, so I can just get that. It's a, no, we're actually okay.
2005. Oh, that was 2005.
Okay. We're actually okay. It's okay, y'all. I can just go on ahead and add this in real quick.
And now the entire stream breaks. Oh, here it is.
No, we're good. Let's go ahead and get this done. 06, bring 08 back down. All right, fellas, now we can continue with your thoughts. Carol, go ahead on the 07 thoughts.
Now, originally when this came out, I didn't have the chance to play it, but I did play a whole bunch of it now in the past year with the emulators being a thing. And I do gotta agree, like, when I see the graphical difference between PS2 and PS3, actually insane, all the details, the models, the presentation. I mean, I love the early SmackDown When It Comes to Pain soundtracks as well. Like, that's a huge thing for me, honestly. The sweat on the models, I don't know, it was still nice, but I felt like for all of those, it lacked kind of a bit of content. It also has an annoying control scheme. So I don't know, I'd actually put this to B just because of the graphical jump, but otherwise I might have even gone down to a C because I don't know, like, especially with 2008, I don't like these games, man. These were not too fun to play. Like, you play them for a couple of matches, it's great, and then the big what do you call it, faults start to show. Like, when the nostalgia goes away, these games were problematic. I gotta be honest with you, so I'm gonna say it's a B in my opinion.
Okay, so we have two A so far, one A. B, go ahead, load it.
A tier. I mean, come on. I mean, I had a lot of fun playing the Buried Alive match. Season mode was a lot of fun. I got this first on the PS2, and then I got the 360. It is such, just the way it looked at the time, it looked so realistic. All the sweat, you know, coming down to on all the superstars. It was a huge improvement. Yeah, I mean, not season mode. GM mode was so much fun. I think I had the most fun in GM mode in that game.
Right.
I remember playing that GM mode in that game for hours. I remember doing a dream match with Brock Lesnar and AJ Styles because I thought it would never happen. And then it eventually did. So, yeah, I thought the gameplay was a lot of fun at the time. Now I'm like, I would kind of criticize it. I don't like the running system at all. The fact that you only get to run in one direction, yeah. But fighting in the backstage area or near the crowd, I think you can fight backstage. I haven't played it in so long. I don't know. Right. I think you can fight backstage. So, yeah.
I don't remember.
I had a lot of fun with it. So, it is the best SmackDown versus Raw game, in my opinion. So, yeah. A tier. There you go.
All right, UTV.
Give it an A.
Well, I definitely do agree with that. The interactive hotspots, they were great. Using the analog to control with the weapons and stuff. Paused the up and down. Also, you know, fighting in the crowd. That was pretty cool. And once again, this was the last and final game we saw Kurt Angle for quite a while. Quite a while. So this game definitely did wonders.
And also Chris B.
Ooh.
Yeah. Actually, that's the last game.
Okay, did you put it in?
And I would definitely give it an F. No, I'm joking. I'll give it an A.
Okay. All right. So, you're the odd man out. So, we're going eights here with SmackDown versus Raw 2007.
I could understand it, though.
All right, man. So, the next one, fellas. Oh, SmackDown versus Raw 2008. All right.
Who's going to kick it off?
All right. If I had to put this game in a tier, I ain't even going to talk too much about it. I'm probably going to go with a C.
Man.
Now, okay. Kenny, you going ahead and go on, my boy.
SmackDown vs. Raw 2008, I am going D tier. Okay. I hated the vibe of this game. I hated the look, the feel, just everything about it. I don't know why. When I think SmackDown vs. Raw 2008, I think Bobby Lashley. And not today's Bobby Lashley. Bobby Lashley from back around that time, and he was just mid. So career mode, everything in that game was just bad to me. So I'm going D tier for SmackDown vs. Raw 2008.
Kiro.
So my experience with this game is that I played it a little bit. I played the career mode and it just felt like TikTok, like the career mode, because your character would be like trying to kiss a diva backstage and then Edge would attack you and then John Cena would attack both of you and then someone else would come in and break it. Like, what was going on? The cutscenes were so weird. The career mode, which is the thing that I'm into the most, was boring. Yeah, it was just... And like I said, I already don't like the gameplay of it that much, like the grappling with the thumbsticks, doing like 10 buttons to Irish whip, the stamina system. I don't know if it was still in this game, but I think it was. It was like very restrictive, even more so than what we had in 2K15 and onwards. So honestly, not a favorite. The only thing I like is, of course, the soundtrack. They kept that pretty awesome. But man, like the biggest thing they introduced, I think, was the fighting styles or whatever. That was kind of a bust as well. So I'm going to have to go with a D for this one as well.
Okay.
Ooh.
Oof. And now my boy Loaded. What's going on, man?
Come on, guys. Yeah, this is a D. This game is the reason why.
Not the only one.
This game is the reason why I took a break from playing these WWE games. Yeah, they introduced different fighting styles. I wasn't a big fan. They improved the running system. They fixed that, but that's pretty much the only thing, the only good thing about it. I mean, they slowed down the gameplay. It wasn't fast paced. Not like SVR07.
Mm-hmm.
The soundtrack was horrible. GM mode is forgettable. Season mode is forgettable. Yeah, this game was a blur to me. Yeah, it was a blur. I didn't like it. I skipped 09, 10, and 11, and 12, and 13 because of this game.
Damn, Jesus.
Man, you missed some good games throughout that run, though, bro.
Yeah.
All right, Brian, you can unhide me now. I'll throw those fries in the air fryer and eat them later. But UTV, where are you going with SmackDown versus Raw 2008?
Man, this game, it basically started the downward trajectory of WWE games. You know, you were just talking about it, the fighting styles, like brawler, technical, all that stuff. It's just such a turnoff. Soundtrack was pretty good. They fixed the running system. One thing I did like was the things you could do with the weapons, like when you could set the chair down and do the Sabu backflip off the ropes, stuff on fire and all that. Like that, stuff was cool. Yeah, the story mode, what was it, like WWE 24/7, just a mess. It's like when you were a kid, you know, it was all right, but like as you get older, you look back, it's like, what was I thinking, what was I playing, like honestly. So my final rating on this, the tier that I'm gonna put it in, definitely not gonna be an A, I'll tell you that. Definitely not gonna be a B, I'll tell you that. I'm gonna have to go with a D.
Boom. Right. SmackDown versus Raw 2008 gets the D.
Whoa.
All right, man.
First one.
All right, man. So first game in the D, we got two games in the A. And now we got SmackDown versus Raw 2009. We got SmackDown versus Raw 2009, and I don't know. And this game feels very forgettable to me. Can't really remember too much. But Kenny, go on ahead and lead us off, man.
You know what? UTV said SmackDown versus Raw 2008 was like the beginning of the downfall of the WWE games. I think it was like a sharp decline. But for 2009, I actually really liked it. They focused back on the tag team aspect of the game, and they put a big emphasis on tag team matches. As you can see on the cover, they had Triple H and Shawn Michaels. I liked a lot about SmackDown versus Raw 2009, so I'm actually going to put this one in an A, just because it was so much better than SmackDown versus Raw 2008.
Okay, Kiro.
This game was definitely an improvement. They did focus on the tag team stuff, and they did add Road to WrestleMania, if I remember correctly. Mm-hmm. We had like the Jericho storyline, a whole bunch of very cool storylines. I really liked the Road to WrestleMania in that game. I think we had CM Punk as
Mask Man, I'm sorry. Mask Man was in this one, right?
Yeah.
Was that 2010?
Kennedy or something? No.
I think it was Randy Orton. He took the mask off in one of the Road to WrestleMania things.
It was one of those. But we had that awesome mode come in, and they definitely like took a step in the right direction. But even then, their tag team matches kind of still sucked. They were more bearable now with the new additions. It was like easier to get through. But like, I would argue older games had better tag team matches that were more fun to play. So I don't know. I'm kind of conflicted. I'm definitely not going an A for this one. I'm going to say it's a C, because again, it was a step in the right direction. Yeah. It wasn't a huge step in the right direction, though. Okay.
And Loaded. My fault, stream. I'll be forgetting I'm driving sometimes. I'm not used to it. But Loaded, go ahead, man.
We're trying to teach him. I see.
I like
had to call you out too with the pause. Yo. We got to try to keep Brian under wraps here, y'all. He be going crazy.
Wrap it up in a car. Go ahead, Loaded.
What's up, Sammy Bear?
I'd love to tell you what tier belongs to, but I never played the game.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah,
hey, that's fair. They lost you with 2008. UTV.
Right. Go ahead, UTV.
Well, with this game, I would, like I said, it did start the downward decline, but I will say I enjoyed it, I guess, a bit better than SmackDown vs. Raw 2008, but it's not saying much. I believe, like somebody in the chat was saying, they had the zombie superstars. That was, they also had, Road to WrestleMania. And I believe this was the first game that they introduced Create a Finisher, isn't it?
Maybe. I remember
it was.
Ten-headed?
I think it was.
That
was really cool. That was really cool. But outside of that, what can I really say? Just a slight better game than SmackDown vs. Raw 2008, and that's about it.
Where would you put it?
I'll put it as a C.
Okay.
Right? I think it gets a B because I put it A.
Oh, I agree with them. It's a C, my boy.
Okay.
That boy put it all the way in the A category.
Well, I put it as an A, so that should give it a little bit of juice, right? To get it back up to a C.
No, we got three of us.
We got three C's, my boy. It's right.
Then we gotta think about Loaded. Loaded. He didn't play it, so you gotta give him the benefit of doubt. He goes up to a B too.
Even if you put it at an A, we still got three C's, my boy. It's
all right, fine. Y'all want to put it C? You know what? I'm fine with that being a C.
Whoa, Johnny in the chat.
Whoa, Johnny.
Looks like he got some fans, Beast.
He was here for Kendo last time.
He actually he go around in circles, bro.
Yeah. All
right, man. So SmackDown versus Raw 2010, fellas.
Let's go.
Okay. So I would say that this game right here was like in the middle for me. It wasn't great. It wasn't the worst, but I had fun. Maybe it was just me being really young. I'm going to put this game in B. Kiro, go ahead.
Okay. I really like started playing heavily wrestling games with 2009. And then I remember 2010 was like also one of the first games that I ever bought. And I don't know, like I remember the entrance or the opening of Road to WrestleMania with the music. I don't know. It was so iconic. I love it for that. Mm-hmm. Kind of has a special place in my heart because of all that. The gameplay itself, it looked nice. Yeah, you know, I remember just playing with Rey Mysterio like 10,000 times. That road to WrestleMania, creative finisher, whole bunch of modes. Like creation mode was pretty sweet at that point. They got a whole lot of things in there. I don't know why, but I just, yeah, maybe it was because of my personal experience, but I really like SVR 010, and I definitely put it at an B tier still. B tier. Oh,
okay. Yeah. All right. And so we got two B's so far. Kenny, you seem to disagree with that. Let us know.
I absolutely disagree with that because, first off, thank y'all for coming to the stream. If you can, please drop a like on this video to help us out. But SmackDown versus Raw 2010 is like the pinnacle of wrestling games. When it comes to the sim wrestling games, this is the best one we ever got. Road to WrestleMania was in here. Create a finisher. Create a story. The graphics look better than ever. If you look at the physics, like the wrestlers that were actually getting caught on the ropes in this game and stuff like that. Just when I got this game, I was like, you know what? It doesn't get any better than this. And we'll talk about later. I don't think it ever did get any better than this. So SmackDown versus Raw 2010 for me is definitely an S tier game.
Whoa.
I can't believe y'all are putting it under an A even. That's crazy.
S tier. Okay, my
S tier. SmackDown versus Raw 2010, S tier wrestling game.
Loaded. I just have to go and assume that you did not play this game neither, my boy, huh?
I just read that guy's comment, Johnny. So, I never played this game. I regret. Yeah, that's, and I regret that very much. I never played it. I wish I did.
Word. UTV, very good. My boy, let us know.
I 100% do agree with Kenny. Like, it feels like although I said, like, SVR 2008 was, you know, the downward spiral, like, these games were just, like, you know, slow bumps. They weren't, like, greatly improving, but they were just, like, slow bumps. So, I'm going to put SVR 2010 at a B. Anything above that, hey, no comment. No comment.
All right, we got to put it in the A slot.
I think it's pretty good at A.
Yeah, I'll let you.
Not at least that preserves our credibility because y'all cannot put 2010. You know what? You got to bump it up to the first one in that A slot too.
Okay, we'll do that. All right,
exactly. Yeah,
let's get it.
All right, man. Let's go on ahead. SmackDown versus Raw, 2011. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. This is the first WWE video game I've ever played in my entire life, dog.
What?
Listen,
what?
I'm a 2002 baby, man. But listen, bro. This game right here got a special place in my heart, bro. It may be similar to 010, but the feeling that SmackDown vs. Raw 2011 gave me back then. This is S tier, my brothers. I ain't going to lie to y'all. This is S tier to me. I love the gameplay. I love the game. The roster was great. I had such a fun time. My boy Kenny, go ahead.
I don't know what it was with SVR 2011 because, as you said, the games were very similar, but for some reason, it just didn't touch me like 2010 did. So I don't know what it was. You know what? I was just like, you know what? This isn't giving me what I got from 2010. I don't like it as much. So for 2011, because I like 2010 so much, I'm going to have to go B tier with it.
Okay. And Kiro, my boy, so we got one S tier. One B tier, where are you going to land at?
For me, this game had everything that 2010 had, just like Kenny just mentioned. It also had Universe Mode. I think it was the first year that came in.
Mm.
Road to WrestleMania.
And the ticking in the crowd.
Yeah. But that was so good, man. Universe Mode is definitely my all-time favorite mode. And I loved it. Like, in the beginning, it was way better anyways than the current version we have. So that was a really strong addition. Road to WrestleMania was still there, and we had so many unique storylines with everybody, like a women's wrestler. I think Mickie James had her own storyline, if I can remember correctly. Like, so variety was there. We could also roam backstage. People still make videos about that and talk about that, wanting that back every single year. Like, it was good. This game was very, very good. And then we had the badass weapon physics. So I'm very conflicted right now. It's definitely A or an S for me. You know what? I might have to go with an S as well.
Okay.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right, man. Ooh, but
wow,
listen, before I move on to the next opinion, y'all make sure to hit that like button, man. We only got 8 likes in here right now. We got 28 people watching. So help us out by hitting that like button so more people tune in. Now, Loaded, my boy, go on ahead and get your opinion going. Oh, I forgot you ain't played this one either, huh?
Nope.
All right. And UTV, my boy, what's going on?
With this game, definitely, man, the backstage free roam, that's going to always, always, always mean a lot to me. That needs to be brought back. The weapon physics, they were great too. You know, being able to set a table wherever you want. You know, weapon physics now, they're all clunky and stuff. You got to like have a perfect placement. Like, it's just terrible now. And all these invisible barriers in these 2K games, don't even let me get started, man. So with that being said, I'll probably, yeah, same spot as 2010, bro. I got to put it at a B, man. I got to put it at a B. All
right, so that bumps it to an A at that point, because there was two S tiers and two Bs. So it bumps it to an A, and it bumps it to the best game in the A tier, fellas. Word. Let's get it. And now the next game. Was this the first SmackDown versus Raw? I might have missed this one.
Yeah, let's get yours real quick.
All right, so listen, I don't got no opinion on this one. My boy Kenny, the old head of the group, he's 28. Go ahead.
Which, y'all, Kenny Baum is 28. I might not be 28, but Kenny Baum is 28. But which one are we going with right now?
SmackDown versus Raw, the first one.
The first SmackDown versus Raw was amazing. Vince McMahon on the cover, right?
Yes.
This was an S-tier game. I remember creating Spider-Man, Venom. I don't know what it was. My brother had a PlayStation. I think it was 2, and I didn't even play PlayStation games, but I was on this one pretty much anytime I could be on it. This was an S-tier game.
Okay. My boy Kiro, what's going on? We got one S-tier.
The thing that I like the most about this game is that this was, out of any game, the one that committed hardest to the name SmackDown vs. Raw, because it's the first game maybe. We had different menus for SmackDown, different menus for Raw. Like, they really cared about that stuff. And again, we had a lot of residue left from Here Comes the Pain, that DNA left. So, you know, there was things like the seated position. There was rest holds that slowed the gameplay down, but it was still pretty good. The season mode was also still kind of the way I liked it as well. So that really just changes everything for me in my eyes. And with all that, I gotta say, yeah, it was a pretty good game. I'm gonna have to put it at an A.
Okay, so we got an A and S tier so far. Loaded, go ahead.
I don't really remember that much about it, but I'm sure I had fun with it. I mean, it's the first time they introduced GM mode, right? I believe so. Yeah, gameplay was
so, yeah.
Yeah, I believe it was the first time. I'm sure the gameplay was fun, but I don't really remember that much about it. So,
all right.
I'm going to put it at, what should I put it? Put it at C.
Okay. C it is for SmackDown versus Raw and UTV.
This game, man, I remember it like it was yesterday when the trailer first dropped. They just don't do them like they used to, man. Who remembers when this trailer first dropped? Generations.
Oh my God.
I was like, yo, what is this? Yeah, man. It really brought you into that SmackDown versus Raw environment. It really did. I believe they had, this was an early edition of Create a Championship, wasn't it? And like Loaded said, GM mode. And also, I believe, wasn't there something like a challenge mode or something?
Oh, I think there was.
I think so.
Yeah.
So yeah, they didn't, real quick, and say GM mode was in 2006, I think. Looking at Google.
Yeah. Okay. But yeah, with that being said, I give this an A.
All right, so we got an S from Kenny. We got a B from Kiro.
Oh, A.
We got two A's. I bet, bro. So this is an A in general. It looks like we got the majority.
I pulled out the chat right now, but the chat voted it an A as well.
All right. There we go. Let's get it. All right, man. So this one right here. Boy, oh, boy. I remember this game because I fell in love with wrestling after grabbing SmackDown.
What are we looking at now?
We're looking at WWE 12.
Before we go to the 12s, let's go back. Let's take it back to the past.
Oh, you want to go all the way back? All
right, yeah, so, something y'all young whippersnappers aren't familiar with.
So let's go on ahead. Here Comes the Pain. Let's go on ahead and talk about this one.
No, I mean, let's go all the way back.
Oh, you would have
WWF Warzone. Let's drop out the Warzone and Attitude. Let's knock those out, and then we'll go back to the.
Let's go ahead and get that done. So, all right, SmackDown, Just Bring It. Is that too?
No, Warzone.
Warzone.
Let's go Warzone, and then we'll go lead into
the second to last.
Oh, all right. The one with Stone Cold. All right, my
man. He don't even know what it is. He don't even know what it is.
Listen, man. All right. So, as Kenny said, I don't know what the hell it is. So, Kenny, please enlighten us.
All right. So, WWF Warzone. This was like the first wrestling game that I remember. I remember WWF, like the WrestleMania game on Super Nintendo, but this was the first one that really like grabbed me, like when it comes to just actually being a quality game, I guess you could call it, because it was different. If you had it on PlayStation, then when you played through like the career modes, you got these promos the wrestlers cut. But if you had it on Nintendo, you didn't quite get that. It was just pretty much like a straight shot, you fighting these wrestlers through the TVs. The creator wrestler mode, I think they were introduced here. Just the fighting style, looking back on it, wasn't great because it was kind of like dial a finisher. Like if you wanted to do the Stone Cold Stunner, you'd go like back, back, forward, X, and then he'd hit the Stone Cold Stunner. Before the matches started, you had Stone Cold doing a quick phrase. I'll drop you on that stack of dimes you call a neck. Just iconic, man. And with this, you know what? You could kind of lump Attitude in here with it because they were pretty much the same games. Attitude was just like a slight improvement. So I'm going to rate these games for the time, say... I'm going to put them in the B category. So you can grab Attitude and Warzone. For me, we can put them in the B category. Did anybody else play these games back then?
Not back then, man, but...
I may have played it one
time. You can speak to them.
I may have played it one time, but I don't really remember it, though. I mean,
Let's put it in a B, but I really like how charming it was. Like, even not just at the beginning of the match, but when they got hit with the woo, like... The way they would sell, it would be their own voice. They would be doing the screaming and all that. Like I thought that was kind of cool. Nowadays, we have like 2,000 people on the roster, so that it's not possible. But I would have liked to seen a modern take on that idea. So I always thought these games were charming because of that.
Yeah. UTV, did you play these?
I've played most of these games, but like those in particular, like that one, I don't think I remember it quite much. But yeah, I've played it before.
Word. Yeah, and RGT said Attitude was better. It was better. I think they didn't have full entrances in Warzone, but they did introduce them in Attitude. But yeah, it was so much good about those games. So yeah, Stone Cold standing like that. So if nobody is aware, then I think, you know what? Just drop them down to a C, Brian. Right. Nobody can debate. Nobody can drop them down for me. So I think they're pretty fair in the C category.
Mm-hmm. All right. Which one do you think was better between Warzone and Attitude? Or do you think
it was Attitude because it was the upgrade?
Okay, so put it at B then.
It wasn't a B.
Oh, all right. All right. So the next one, Raw's War.
Oh, my goodness. Who wants to? Did anybody else play that one?
I can't tell if that's bad or good reaction.
Yeah, you RGT's right. He's dropping some gems in there. You did have the season mode and Attitude as well. But did anybody else play WWF Raw?
Is that like N64?
That's Xbox, the original Xbox. The reason I bought an Xbox. Well, I got one for Christmas. I asked my mom. She got it.
I think, was it on PC ever?
I think it might have been on PC, but I don't know.
First time I played it, I played it on PC. I didn't get it on Xbox.
If so, man, that game made me drunk. Like, it actually made me nauseous just watching the gameplay because it was so blurry. It was so shaky. It was weird, but it was the only WWE game I had. Growing up, I mostly had a PC for a while, so I was starving for any kind of WWE game, and this was it, man. And after, like, I had to play this game, and after playing anything else, I was like, holy crap, wrestling games are so much better than I thought. Like, I was literally torturing myself. This might be the worst game, one of the worst games that I've played in my life. And I don't wish it on my worst enemy. I will put this into D tier, send it down to hell. If there's an F tier, send it down to F tier, man. No.
You know what, Kato? I 100% agree. But I will say the game looked great. Phenomenal. I remember when I first got the Xbox, they had a picture of the game. I was like, man, I can't wait till this thing comes out because it looks so good. The graphics were the best at that time. But you're right. When you got in there and like if you threw a punch, like it just looked terrible. It felt terrible. It had the Undertaker on his bike. So I mean, I guess you got to give it that. But like this, I don't even know if it was a season career. I think it was like a ladder, like a Mortal Kombat ladder you played through. And Fred Durst was in there. Just, it was bad. It was terrible. Oh, yeah. Create a wrestler. That's this is a D tier. Oh, we got an F?
Oh, we got an F.
We got an F.
This is F, yeah. F tier.
Yeah, throw it in there. F out, man.
Oh, one thing I loved, couldn't you attack someone during the entrance in this one?
I think you could, yeah. I think they did.
I think this was the first wrestling game where you could do that. That's what I liked about it. Everything else?
Bad.
Yeah, I think you wear stuff good. Too. Like you could wear a hat.
Man, damn, this game sound booty cheeks, bro.
Oh, wait, yeah, because you could wear a hat and the hat could come off, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Pick him up and hit him with the hat. The weapons were so bad in this too.
Yeah.
Oh man.
You know, there's some things they got right, but everything else.
I don't know what they got right, Loden. The graphics. That's all I can say.
All right.
Did you play this one UTV?
Yeah, I played, and I 100% agree. I don't even got to speak on it. Throw it in the F. You can throw Raw 2 in the F category too.
Somebody said S tier. Kick him out the chat.
Whoa, you good? You good over there, bro?
Out the chat, whoever said that.
Oh, boy. All right, man.
Ryan, let's try to follow it up with Raw 2.
All right, Raw 2. Okay, so what we're doing, we're throwing this in F2? Okay.
Please.
Let's talk about it.
All right, so Raw 2, I didn't play this. I see Goldberg, Triple H, and I can't really tell who the other guy is, but let's go on ahead and continue. Okay, word. Scott Steiner. No disrespect. Kenny Bomb, go on ahead and let us know how you feel about this game.
But Raw 2 was an improvement over Raw. You could tell it was the same engine, so it was still slow and it was still like sluggish, but they had a pretty interesting. It was a different type of career mode in this. Like you had like different choices where you could like meet somebody backstage and jump them. It was like a lot of different things you could do in it, but the core issue was still there, and that was the fact that the gameplay was just not good. And I wasn't a Goldberg fan because I wasn't a WCW guy, and I hated the fact that they put him front and center on the cover, so that made it even worse for me. But you know what? Raw 1 was so bad. And this one was an improvement. So instead of going F, I'm going to go D with this one.
All right. I just want to announce that there's a tier lower than F, and it's called butt cheeks. If a game was literal butt cheeks, you going ahead and let us know when it's going down there, my boy.
Oh, I know what's going down there.
All right.
Anybody else played Raw 2 that want to speak on it?
Yes, sir.
I agree with everything you said.
Mm-hmm. All right, UTV?
Yeah, I mean, I guess just a little bit better than Raw 1, but still, I guess give it a D. But
okay. That's some like novel ideas. Someone pointed out in chat.
Yeah,
like,
it was good ideas, just poor gameplay behind them. But go ahead and put Raw on booty cheeks. So let's put Raw 2 was a D. We're gonna give Raw 2 the D, but Raw 1 got to get the booty cheeks.
All right. So, the next one, bro, we're going to go with Day of Reckoning.
Ooh. Ooh, you got to go with the first one. That's the second one.
Yeah. Trish.
And Randy Orton.
There you
Young
go.
Boy, there it goes. Who wants to kick it off with Day of Reckoning?
Go ahead.
Anyone played it?
Sounds like I played it.
I never had a GameCube.
Oh, okay.
I can't talk about it, bro.
For me, Day of Reckoning is S tier. The only thing I didn't like about Day of Reckoning was the fact that, like, and it's realistic, but I just don't like it. Like, you hold your opponent up for a vertical suplex. If somebody else comes in and hits you while you're up in the air, the move kind of breaks up. Everybody collapses. Oh, nice. But when it comes to gameplay, story, just everything they put in this game, definitely S.
Okay. Yeah. Are you the only person who played this?
I played like before this WrestleMania 18. I think I really liked the gameplay style of that, so I went back with an emulator. Yeah, and played Day of Reckoning, and it's pretty good. It's pretty damn good.
So where are we putting this at, Kiro?
Hold on. I think I would put it at an A. Like I just don't like the finisher system that much. Right. Never been a big fan.
Day of Reckoning is an A. It is an A.
All right, so I guess we're going with A.
Hold on, we got to get the chat's opinion. That took too long.
Oh, go ahead. You're good.
All right, chat, get the votes in for Day of Reckoning really quick. Right now, it's sitting at an A, but we're going to see if it's going to be locked in at an A. Do y'all think it's less, or should we go higher? Let it get much higher.
Yeah.
Oh, we got some A's. We got some B's.
Got some B's knees.
Any more votes before we close it? Oh, we got some B's. We got another A.
Uh-oh.
Ooh. There's more B's than I thought.
Whoa. RGT said Day of Reckoning is great, but the story mode was idiotic. Oh, man. The story mode was my favorite part. That was my favorite part. It was like, I think like you got kicked out of WWE or something, and you had to like work your way to get back in there.
Yeah,
I mean, you had all kind of backstage stuff going on. I want to stream it on here. So we're going to stick with A. The chat votes A. So I think that's a good one. I'm with y'all on that. And you know what? Day of Reckoning 1 and 2 pretty much in the same boat.
Yeah, they're pretty much the same.
Would you say the same for WrestleMania? X9, X8, kiddo?
I might put them one down because as like those games were awesome, but the story mode was just... it was funny, but it was annoying. I don't know. And it wasn't like as good as Day of Reckoning, so it would be one tier down.
Yeah, I agree. So I say Day of Reckoning 1 and 2, let's put them in A's, and then for the WrestleMania X9 and X8, we'll put those in B.
All right. WrestleMania... elaborate. Who's on the cover of these games, man? This is, you know.
Oh, man. Here we go.
You're right on it. You're right on it.
You're right there. Those two right there.
Put them in B. That one,
B. No, Day of Reckoning with Stacy Keibler, you got to put that in A.
That revenge mode, though, man, you cannot tell me that was not one of the best game modes ever introduced into a wrestling game, bro. Come on.
That was super unique.
All right. So, fellas, we're almost getting down to the nitty gritty. How about WrestleMania 2000? I ain't played this neither, so let me know.
Oh, man.
Who wants to start off? Go ahead. UTV.
WrestleMania 2000, you know, like, I hear a lot about, you know, no mercy, no mercy, no mercy, but man, where is the love for WrestleMania 2000? Like, come on, bro. I'm going to go ahead and put this in the A category. Come on now. You know.
Kenny, go ahead.
Here you go.
Maybe I'm very generous, but I'm putting WrestleMania 2000 in the S category. Like I said, before WrestleMania 2000, we were playing WWF Attitude, WWF Warzone, and just that jump in quality with WrestleMania 2000 was just amazing. Of course, everybody praises No Mercy just because that's where everything was refined. But I had a lot more fun with WrestleMania 2000 because that's when we first got the great wrestling game. And it was, you know what? The difference between WWF Warzone and WrestleMania was a lot bigger than the difference between WrestleMania 2000 and No Mercy. So I'm going S tier with WrestleMania 2000.
All right. Carol, we got an S and an A so far.
Well, I'm going to go for an A. And the only thing it's holding us back is the game modes. Like, the everything was great. But again, we needed that extra stuff. And that's what holds it back from an S for me.
Mm-hmm. All right. Loaded?
I'll give it an A. Yeah, sure.
All right.
I prefer the other game that came after it. We'll talk about it. But WrestleMania 2000 was a very fun game at the time.
It was pretty good.
I had a lot of fun playing it with my brothers and sisters growing up. So, it goes into A tier.
I think you just finished it off, so let's go ahead and jump into the next one, which is No Mercy. Do you have it on the list, Brian?
Yes, I do, my boy.
All right, I see it. I see it.
All right, so No Mercy, we're going to go on ahead and start with...
This is very messy.
Hero.
All right. Okay, well, let's start with No Mercy. Would I call this the greatest wrestling game of all time? I don't think so, because there's a lot of nostalgia speaking, I feel like, when people talk about this game. My main gripes with it is... The thing I like the most is, like, you actually have to wrestle a match. So you can't go in there and do a powerbomb. You have to start with small stuff and, you know, work an actual match, like I said. So I really enjoyed that. The amount of moves, the way the wrestlers sell them for its time, by the way, it's insane. It's really, really good. On a modern lens, though, what I see is that the AI is just way too easy. Once you get the hang of it, it presents you no threat, which is concern with most of the wrestling games I have. But other than that, like, for example, it has the, what do you call it, the season mode or the championship mode, which I went through a couple of times. It's, you know, short. I don't know, like, it doesn't really interest me. It's nice. It's, again, for its time, it's amazing. It also has like a Royal Rumble mode, which takes 10 hours to finish. But I gotta say, I would put it simply because of the gameplay and like the amount of flexibility it gives you. It's great, but again, it's gonna be the game modes that hold it back for me, because like everything is great about it. The roster is amazing, the gameplay is amazing, but then again, what are you gonna do with that gameplay? That's my only concern. That's why I'm not putting it at an S. Maybe a little controversial, but hey,
okay,
that's what I feel.
Okay, and Loaded, let us know how you feel about this game.
I'm about to give it a A, Mike. No, I gotta give it S tier. Okay. I mean, I had a lot of fun with this shit, with this game growing up. So much fun with my brothers and sisters, man. It doesn't have a lot of match types, but the most important thing that we need in a wrestling game is match creator. Yes, even in a Royal Rumble match, you could turn on pins. You could put KO on, yeah. I believe. Mm-hmm. So yeah, that was a great addition. I think we have King of the Ring, a tournament mode in the game. The gameplay is great. Yeah, I had a lot of fun growing up. So this may be the greatest wrestling game of all time. So S tier.
All right.
That's where it belongs.
Let's do it. All right. And UTV, let us know, my boy, how you feel about this game.
I don't get what all the hype is about, man. You know where it goes. It goes in the cheek section. Nah, I'm joking. I'm going to go ahead and, you know, I had to show love to WrestleMania 2000. But, yeah, this game is definitely better, and I will put it in the S tier. Above WrestleMania 2000.
All right, perfect. Me, personally, I played this game before. I put it in A, but it looks like the general consensus has it in S.
So even though you didn't ask my opinion, y'all, this is why we don't let Brian.
You answered first, bro.
I did not.
You did it?
But yeah, no, I agree. S tier for No Mercy. If WrestleMania 2000 was S tier and No Mercy added to that, kind of fixed everything it was missing, then I'd put it in the same category. Looks like the chat split 50-50 between S and A, but we got so many S's going all over the place. I think we got to go S tier for No Mercy.
All right, let's do it. All right, man.
Is that the only game we got in S tier so far?
Yes, that is the first entrance.
Ooh, No Mercy.
Oh,
that is S tier,
you know?
All right.
All right, and let's go with... Is that called Crush Hour?
Yep.
Yes, Kittle put this in here. Let's make Kittle lead the cup.
You can go right ahead and put it the butt cheeks. I mean, the idea was cool. I don't even know if the idea was cool. Like, this is wrestlers, but you're in like twisted metal. I don't know who came up with it. I applaud their bravery, but it just didn't work out, man. It just didn't work out.
All right.
I remember seeing it in like the, I think it was like the Game Informer or Xbox Now magazines or something, but I thought it got canceled. I didn't even know this made it to the market. So
It is actually out there.
But hey, I respect them for trying something different. You know, we don't get that these days. So it was butt cheeks, I'm sure.
Yeah.
They tried it.
All right, so we are, is the general consensus on this game butt cheeks? I've never actually heard of it before.
That's a good thing.
I've never played it, so I'm going to agree with that, butt cheeks.
All right.
It's definitely there.
So that game is butt cheeks, fellas, and we're going to go on ahead and get into Immortals.
So this is the WWE game that was made by NetherRealm Studios, the team that makes Mortal Kombat and Injustice. I don't play mobile games, so I never got into it. Did anybody ever try this one?
No. I tried it, and I thought it was nice because it basically, we talked about it before the stream. It was Injustice, but WWE style. And at that time, I was playing Injustice a whole bunch because all my other friends were playing, so they kind of got me into it. And Immortals was nice, man. I like the creativity, but obviously it's not going to make it, for me, high on the list. It's a phone game after all. They got a certain ceiling. They can never be an S tier. I'm going to say it was an enjoyable game. I'd put it at like a C.
Okay. So C for that game. And
all right. But I do want to say, I mean, I wanted to get that on the list because that was made by NetherRealm Studios, and they also made WWF Attitude on Super Nintendo. No, WWF WrestleMania, like the arcade game where The Undertaker had a fatality. So they've been working with WWE, and right now we want to see a different type of wrestling game. So I hope sometime in the future, whatever, they can team up and put out a console game made by somebody like NetherRealm Studios. I think
if they made Immortals like not for phones but actual consoles, I think that would be super sick.
Yep.
Okay.
I think so too.
Anybody else play Immortals in here and wants to put their input?
Right. I don't see any Immortals loving it. Oh, Carol says Immortals was cool. Like, example, Dean Ambrose finisher consisted of his gimmick, the Asylum Hannibal Lecter type style. Yes, that's why I want to see this something like this on the console. Because they can do so much with these wrestlers and their gimmicks, like putting it in like fighting game like this. Yep. So it'll be cool. But you said C, Kidder, or D?
Which one? And it's with everything taken into account, C is good.
Yeah, let's go C.
All right, so C it is, y'all. And let's go on ahead and talk about Here Comes the Pain.
Oh man.
I'll lead this one off, man. I obviously wasn't born when the game was out, but I still play this game till this day.
Baby.
I still play this game till this day, bro. I cannot even lie. And I've had so much fun with this game. So I'm definitely going to go with S for Here Comes the Pain. Go ahead, Kenny.
So for me, you know what? Here Comes the Pain might just be the best wrestling game of all time. So I'm definitely going S tier. And even though No Mercy is at that S tier, and I know everybody loves No Mercy so much, Here Comes the Pain was such a perfect game. I think I'm going to go above No Mercy with Here Comes the Pain in that S tier category.
Okay. So now we got two S's. Kiro, my boy, let us know.
On with the highest possible rank ever, S. Because just the season mode alone is enough for me. Like, I don't know. I probably put over or close to like 1,000 hours to this game over my lifetime. It's infinitely replayable. It's awesome. Has all the creation parts. You can create your own taunts. The way you walk, the way you run, the way you stand. You can actually have control over that. It's insane on so many levels. Just like, it has, of course, problems, but the positives are so much, you know, overwhelming that there's no other way. It's got to be an S.
Not to mention the backstage areas.
Yeah, backstage. Like, even the vibrations, like, the way they hit. Like, it feels better than the current games because, like, right when the move has its impact, it's like, vibrates at the right spot. You know what I mean? I'm sure you fellas understand.
Yeah. Lotus, what kind of love or hate do you have for Here Comes the Pain?
This game is butt cheeks, bro.
Whoa.
What? For real. Yeah.
I'm
no,
waiting
no,
for
no,
no, right
no.
Now.
All Siren is not. This is S tier, man. I mean,
oh, okay.
On,
it took a little too long.
S tier, man. Probably my favorite wrestling game, man. For real. Like, you get to fight in Times Square.
Yeah.
You get to climb on the buildings. I think you get to ride on the chopper, I believe.
Yeah, you
can. You can't drive it, but you get to ride it. Yeah,
oh, you can jump off it.
Yeah, you could jump off it. That shit was crazy. You get to fight backstage. The gameplay was great. Everyone had their own fighting stance. It was the first time they introduced the Elimination Chamber.
Yeah.
They had a stacked roster.
Yeah.
S tier, bro.
The good Elimination Chamber before they started putting the pads and everything down.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, they ruined it.
All right.
UTV, what you got for Here Comes the Pain?
I 100% agree. Like, man, you can just look at the gameplay today. Go up when you have the time. Look up WWE Here Comes the Pain Extreme Moments, man. Stacking up like 2, 4, 6 tables, crashing them all down, going from Times Square to the ring, to the parking lot, to the back, the shopping carts, the forklifts, the doing an F5 on the car. Like, just so many memories, man. So many memories. This game is 100% going in the S tier. Is there an S plus tier? Where is it at?
We don't got no S plus tier right now, bro, but we might make one. But man, listen. So
the chat agrees too. Chat agrees with a solid. Well, it's 90%, but yeah, that's overwhelming. So
yeah,
here comes the pain. Big W.
Sure. So all right, y'all. So let's go on ahead and get the SmackDown games. Are they similar? Or are they? Do each of them bring different features? I'm not aware. I haven't played.
Some of them are actually, besides one, all of them are now PS1 titles, I think.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, so I was on Nintendo 64 at this time, so I'm.
So you did not play
out of the loop. I played them at friend's house, but that's it.
All right. And would you rate it, or you didn't play enough to rate it?
I didn't play enough to rate it.
Okay. Kiro.
So we're talking about the first SmackDown game.
SmackDown. Just bring it.
Yeah.
Of course, I didn't play it when it came out, but I did play it later on. And I don't know, these games are nice. Like, they're obviously very crude, very simple, but they're really fun. They're like really fun. We can boot it up today and we'll have a ton of fun. It has a decent sized roster, you know, crazy moves. It's got everything of like all the fundamentals a fun wrestling game needs. It is easily 10 times better than like Raw or Crash R. I'd put it over Raw 2 as well. I think I would even put it, yeah, somewhere between C and B for me.
Okay.
And I'm gonna, yeah.
This is for the
right, Loden, were you playing the SmackDown games on PlayStation?
The first SmackDown.
Yeah, I remember playing it, but I don't remember everything about it, but I had fun playing it at the time, so I'll give it a C.
Okay.
I'd love to tell you what features it had, but I don't remember, bro, so.
UTV? Yeah.
Didn't have much the first game.
Yeah, same as Kenny. Like, I mean, there was a point in time where I did eventually own it, but I was mainly playing it at a friend's house. But yeah, I'll definitely give it a C.
All right, so C it is, and that sits in C, and SmackDown 2.
I think he followed up the same.
Yeah,
unless anybody else got anything different.
It had a season mode, whole bunch of new match types. It was nice. It was a nice upgrade. More a roster too. But I wouldn't put it at B with WrestleMania. Maybe. No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't. It would stay there. It would be better than SmackDown 1.
Everybody agree on C?
Yes, that's fine.
All right. So I guess I can put this one in front of the last SmackDown, though, in front of the first one.
To be honest, I would put it over like Warzone 2.
Okay. All right. Now, SmackDown Just Bring It. Anyone play this one?
I remember playing it, but not enough. Again, I didn't have it in the house, so not too strong on that.
Was this the first PS2 game?
I think it was after SmackDown 1 and 2, right? I think this was like SmackDown 3.
I might have played Hold On.
I remember playing it. It was a good game. You get to free roam backstage in season mode. So yeah, I had fun with it.
Oh, this is
like, you got to bump SmackDown 2 up one. RGT says B for SmackDown 2. Anybody else in the chat played SmackDown 2? If y'all got opinions on this, let us know.
Yeah.
But for right now, I think we need to bump it up to 2.
I think one of them had a like a double special guest referee match. I forgot which one it was.
A double special guest referee.
Yeah, you could have two referees in one match, but I forgot which game it was.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about, Loaded. I just can't remember either.
I think this game also
bring it at C.
Let you have like eight people in the rumble.
Let's talk about shut your mouth.
Okay,
you shut your mouth.
I was able to play shut your mouth.
Shut your mouth was good.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a good game, man.
Felt like pre Here Comes the Pain.
Yeah, that's what it honestly feels like. If I had to put this game in anywhere, I would probably put it in A.
I was going to say the same thing.
I don't think it's as good as Here Comes the Pain, as that is probably the undisputed GOAT at the moment. But Shut Your Mouth was pretty close, so I would put it in A.
Yeah, now, it was just about to evolve.
That was like Brock's first
appearance. Shut Your Mouth.
That was Brock's first appearance in the game, so I was like excited for that game because huge fan.
One thing I got to shout out, though, I wish they didn't take it out, was like you could grab somebody from the ground and he could immediately go into a grapple. Like you wouldn't have to pull him up and then go for another grapple. Like that was so nice. It would keep the gameplay so smooth. I don't know why they took it out.
Yeah, that's cool.
All right. And UTV?
That game, although I did enjoy Here Comes the Pain better, I guess I'll put it one step below it in the A category.
All right.
I used to love doing a Swanton or a frog splash off of the SmackDown fist. Mm-hmm. That was my game, man.
I was glad Triple H was on the cover.
We're going to go in ahead and put this in A. And now to rate the last game of those old times, WrestleMania 21, fellas.
Oh, boy.
Butt cheeks.
Boy. You know what? It wasn't booty cheeks. What? WrestleMania 21 was not butt cheeks. WrestleMania 21 was actually... Okay, I wanted to play the game so bad because the graphics were really good, but like when you got it, it didn't work. There was an issue that the game would just freeze. It just freeze. Like you playing in the match, the game would just freeze. You got to cut it off, cut it back on. It had a pretty good career mode too, but just with all the bugs in the game not working, the gameplay wasn't perfect, but I think it was something they could have improved upon and made it something good down the line. But the fact that it just didn't work really killed it. I remember I had to send it off to them in the mail. I couldn't wait to get this game, y'all. Like, this was like, I was probably more hyped for this game than I was any other one. Because I was like, Xbox is finally getting a good wrestling game, and I got it. It didn't work. I had to mail it back to them, wait for them to send it back. They sent it back, and it still didn't work. So, I mean, I powered through it and played it, but just because of the bugs, I got to go F. I'm not going to let y'all put it in booty cheeks, though.
All right. And Kiro.
I concur.
Okay. And Loaded.
I'm with Penny. F.
Okay.
I'm still sad about this game, y'all. Like, my heart's broken right now, even talking about it.
Because I played it a couple times, and this is me. This is I'm used to playing the PS2 game, so I went from PS2 to trying out this game. I'm all like, F.
All right, so we have F, and I'm pretty sure UTV made it very clear. UTV, do you have any additional input aside from butt cheeks?
Man, just like Kenny was saying, one of my fondest memories of this game, man, you do not know how pissed off I was. So I put this game in my Xbox, bro. I am so ready to do a Hell in a Cell match, Batista versus Triple H. Every single time, making my Xbox sound like it's about to explode. I was so sad, bro. Like, I'll never forget that. F.
Terrible, man.
F
terrible.
Or butt cheeks, either one. You too.
All right. So F it
had
is.
Potential.
All right. So we're about to get into the modern day era of these games.
Modern day Maharaja.
Do not hinder agenda.
All right. So we're gonna start it off with WWE All-Stars. And I think this game had some mixed opinions. I think some people thought it was really good, and I think some people thought it was mid. Personally, I'm on the side of really good. I think this was an A-tier game for what it was. I think it was a great game. I wouldn't put it in S. I think it would be between A or B for me. I wouldn't be mad if it went in any of those tiers. Anything lower, respectfully, you're tripping. Now, Kenny, go on ahead and give us your opinion.
WWE All-Stars was S, the best arcade wrestling game of all time. I wish it had a better story mode, but when it comes to getting in there playing matches in the ring, I would put this up against Here Comes the Pain. When it comes to the in-ring stuff, just being able to do those combos, throw the wrestler up in the air, catch him, jump down, it was a beautiful game. I had so much fun playing it with my brothers and my friends at the house. You know what? It shocked me because I was like, oh, this is a joke. This is a goofy game. I buy all wrestling games, so I'm going to get it. And I played this game for a long time. I still have fun playing it today, even though I took those L's to Kiro. Shout out to that young man. But yeah, I can't go less than S tier. Of course, I would put it behind Here Comes the Pain and No Mercy. But when it comes to a wrestling arcade game, I can't go less than that.
Okay. So we have those opinions. And now Kiro, going ahead and let us know.
Man, at the time, this game also snuck up on me just because I like realized or saw a trailer of it like 1 week or something before it released. I was like, all right, let me get this. And now most of the list, I hit some of the games with, oh, this game doesn't have enough content and that's why it's not an S and it's an A. For this, I'm going to kind of bypass that because like Kenny said, the gameplay was so much fun that it's maybe the second game ever that I played online in when it comes to wrestling. Like, I think I played online in WWE 13 just to see it, but like, All-Stars was so much fun. Like, even when I was doing like an elimination match and I was going up against two people, I want to be careful with my words here. I was like Edge and I would double spear people and beat them at the same time. It was so satisfying. Even when I lost, it was awesome. So I gotta go with an S, man. Like, if this game. I also had the content. It would be right up there with Here Comes the Pain. So All-Stars was really, really good. I wish they go back to it and do something similar.
Sir, I agree. And now, Loaded, let us know,
man. I've only played the demo for this game, not the full game. Oh, I played a couple matches. So, yeah, I had fun with it, but I put it in, like, the B category.
Oh, come on.
Oh, I can't hear you.
Check the chat, Kiro. I was thinking the same thing.
Yo, Loaded, your mic is muted.
Oh, God damn it.
That opinion was so bad that it muted out your mic, bro.
All right, let's go ahead and go with UTV.
Yeah, UTV, go ahead, my boy.
Hello?
Oh, yeah, we got you. You good.
All right. Did you guys hear what I said?
You said it was B.
Yeah, you gave it a B because of the demo.
Yeah, I only played the demo. I didn't put a lot of time into it, so yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right, what you got, UTV?
You know, when this game first came out, you know, I was really scratching my head. You know, it was just something we've never seen before. It was really unique. So, you know, as with all games, can't judge a book by its cover until you actually pick it up and play it. So I was actually at WrestleMania Fan Access. I attended WrestleMania 27, and I just remember it like it was yesterday. I mean, I wasn't really familiar with the controls, but I just, you know, I got familiar with it, and I was just beating folks, pause,
whoa,
beating folks left and right at Fan Access. And true story. So as I was exiting Fan Access, you will not guess who I saw in the room playing this game.
Hornswoggle.
Yes. So really? Hornswoggle was really sitting down.
Serious? Did I get it?
I'm not even joking. Hornswoggle was sitting down in front of this ginormous flat screen TV, opening a family sized bag of Skittles, just gaming. Like, if you can get a Hornswoggle to game like that, you know it's a good game. So although I will not give it an S tier, I'll give it, I mean, it's up to you. You can put it in a B, you can put it in an A, but it was definitely unique. I did enjoy it for sure.
But look at this. The chat locks at 44% at S tier and
let's 44%
go. Less. Wow, that's like a very split opinion there. But that A tier brings it up to 50%.
Yeah.
That on a positive side.
All right. So
where do you lock it at, Brian?
I don't know. I don't want to make this call. I mean, the chat, let me see. The chat thinks, can we get one more person to vote? Has everybody voted?
One more person. Let's see. No, everybody hasn't voted. Let's
see.
We got
25 people
else
here. We got 9 votes. Can we just get one more?
Help us. If we can get one vote for S tier, then we'll put it in S tier. If we can get one for less, then I think we got to go A.
Yep.
Somebody drop a vote.
Okay.
Oh, we got to go A.
All right.
Shout out to vote 10. I think it's a high A, though. I think it's a high A.
Yeah, for sure.
I agree. All right, fellas. So, let's talk about Battlegrounds for a minute, man. Ooh. This game right here.
A lot of people thought
that this was going to be WWE All-Stars 2.0. And this game ended up having 5 different moves. And that was it. I'm personally going to go with butt cheeks. Now, Kenny, are you sticking with that butt cheeks decision?
I'm going with the strongest booty cheeks. I'm talking Jade Cargill, man. I don't know what happened with this. When they put this out, I was like, oh, we got another WWF All-Stars on our hands, or WWE All-Stars. That's the old head coming out again. But this just wasn't it. Every wrestler pretty much had the same moves, and you had to grind to unlock so many other wrestlers. I was like, I'm not doing this, and I just stopped playing it. But, yeah, this is straight booty cheeks.
Okay, Kiro.
Oh, man, I'll put it at an F just because the gameplay was there. The moves were not there, but the gameplay, like at first, there was some potential with this. And if the moves were there and if they did some things differently, this would have been a pretty decent game. Definitely not an A tier, maybe not even a B tier, but like you would not be at the butt cheeks section right now. For me, it's an F. It just had a little bit of something, but I mean, microtransactions out of the wazoo, like they were trying to get every single pin you had. So that's, yeah.
All right. So we have an F and 2 butt cheeks so far. No pun intended. Loaded.
Now you got 3 butt cheeks. I never played it, so I'm gonna agree with you guys.
All right, perfect. And UTV, my boy.
Man, this game was so awful. Oh my goodness. It's like you were just saying, you thought you were gonna get a WWE All-Stars 2.
Yeah.
Not even close. This game was terrible. I saw the trailer, you got wrestlers being thrown in like an alligator pit and all this. I'm like, what is this?
Yeah.
This game was so bad. I believe it ended up on PlayStation Plus. I just one day wake up, I'm like, why is this game in my library? This game was just bad. But yeah, to finish off what I was saying, what a terrible time to be a wrestling gamer. You have WWE 2K20 and then you have Battlegrounds followed up by that. Mm-hmm. Terrible. Terrible. Beautiful. Booty, butt cheeks.
Okay, So we got that figured out so far, y'all. Now let's get into the rest of the series. So right. WWE 12 is the first game on my list. And I was so excited about this game because I had just bought 2011 the year before. And I was just counting down the days. I drove my father crazy with this game. I still remember the pre-order bonus. The pre-order bonus was The Rock. And I was just driving my dad crazy. We even went to GameStop to get this game so I could get the pre-order bonus, bro. And the universe mode in this game was actually freaking awesome. This is probably the best universe mode that we've had, in my opinion. And I wish 100%. That I wish that I was like more educated on what universe mode was so I could enjoy it more. But I was so young at the time. But yeah, WWE 12, I'm going to put this in A tier. Kenny, go ahead.
Now, earlier, UTV said SmackDown versus Raw 2008 was the downfall of these wrestling games. I hate to bring it up again, but I say SmackDown, WWE 12 was actually the beginning of the downfall of these games. Again, SmackDown versus Raw 2010 was just so good to me. I loved that game so much. I didn't get that back with 11, and I feel like WWE 12 was even worse. This one just didn't strike for me. I was looking forward to it, you know, with the whole Randy Orton stuff, the change in the aesthetic, SmackDown versus Raw is gone. But when I actually got in there and played it, for some reason, it just didn't deliver for me. So I'm going C.
Okay. All right. C. And the RGT seems to agree with you with C as well. Kiro, how do you feel about this game, man?
This one's tough. We had the Apex Predator technology, Brock Lesnar returning and all that. Like, you could break up moves now. That was the big thing. You could do more finishers out of nowhere instead of, like, gut-kicking people. I mean, there was some nice stuff. I think corner finishers were, like, kind of changed with this one as well. But, man, I didn't like that much the Road to WrestleMania because it was a Sheamus storyline where you got all the titles. They did a lot of things were like, wrong where you would absolutely kick ass during the gameplay. And then when there was a cutscene, you were like a jobber. I hated that. And the storyline was itself was not too interesting. You still had the remaining modes from SVR 10, 11, but they were not really changed that much or improved upon. Besides Universe Mode, which I played throughout the entire year. Basically, I spent so much time on that Universe Mode. It was so dynamic. Yes. That's the only reason that this game is going to be a B for me instead of like a C or D. That Universe Mode just takes it up much higher. Okay. So I'm going to go with a B.
So we got an A, B, and C loaded.
I skipped out on this one.
Oh, you did? Okay. So UTV, my boy, go ahead.
I wasn't really like that hyped for this game. Like, it was straight. I mean, it wasn't the worst we've gotten, but it was all right. I guess you could put it at a C.
All right, so we got two Cs. What does the chat say?
The chat's saying B.
Okay, so do we just agree and put it B and just leave it in the middle?
I think so. Joseph says it's mid, and yeah, I agree.
Back B, yeah.
All right, so B it is. Now, all right, this is actually my second favorite wrestling game of all time in WWE 13. Boy, did I have fun on this
no,
game.
The second wrestling game he's ever played, so keep
no,
going.
No, no, no. The hours. The hours I clocked into this game, bro. We're crazy. Fun fact, I used to live in the Dominican Republic at the time. My dad made sure to ship this game to me. Hurricane Sandy was happening at the time, and I was real sad because I thought I wasn't going to get the game for another week. I got it the third day after the game came out. But WWE 13, man, they introduced the OMG moments, had one of the biggest rosters of all time. Like, this game right here, online was amazing. I don't know how many of y'all played online at the time, but online was my thing. That's all I did back then. I was in a clan. I did all that, bro. I was a kid at the time, so it was fun. I love WWE 13. I got to go with A as well for this one, bro. I'm not going to lie. So, Kenny, go ahead, my boy.
So for WWE 13, I'm going with D because this is kind of where I got that. This is where I got the fatigue where I'm like, okay, these games are kind of the same now, and they're not getting better. So after 13 is kind of where I got exhausted with the franchise. So I'm going to go D with it.
Okay. Kiro, so we got an A and a D.
I agree, man. Like, WWE 12, I remember I was just so disappointed after SVR 2011. Like, oh, this is basically the same thing, just a little different. WWE 13, it was that, but magnified, because I felt like the changes were even more minor now compared to SVR 11 to WWE 12. The color of the game was nice. Like, it was more vibrant. I like that. The menu, I mean, I was a big fan. Still, I'm a big fan of CM Punk. So him being on there was cool. The Attitude Era... storyline or whatever we got, that was also nice.
Yeah,
but like at the time I really didn't care about the Legends roster, so like that didn't do much for me too. I did actually play a lot online in that game as well. Like, I remember, I think the roll-ups were a new thing now with the thumbsticks, and I just remember doing like 10,000 roll-up reversals, and the match would never ever freaking end. But I gotta say, it's for me, it's lower than WWE 12, so I'll put it at a C. It's just like, oh my god, please do something new, change stuff. Yeah, that's what I felt as well.
Okay, UTV, my boy, go ahead.
Hey, like you, that online, man. My first time playing online, it was either 2010 or 2011, but when it really heated up was 13, man. The wars I had on WWE 13 were so crazy, and I remember it like it was yesterday. That the marketing they had with CM Punk and Stone Cold when they were sitting down with Jim Ross, it was like, now what would you do if I were to, like, man, it just felt so real, like they were about to clash. You can literally go on the WWE Games page right now. That is still, to this day, the most viewed video. So this game definitely was hitting, and I give it not an S, but I guess I will give it an A or a B, maybe. Okay. a B.
Looks like it's a popular opinion.
Yeah. All right. So B. All right. Cool. And loaded. My fault, Brody. Go ahead, my boy.
No, I mean, SVR 08 was so disappointed. I skipped out on this one too. So.
Okay. Oh yeah. Wow! I thought it was only until 12.
You had a whole hiatus, bro. All right. So listen. So right now we have for the poll, 13 is actually 56%. I said A for that, and A is 56%. UTV said A, and Kiro and Kenny said D and C, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yep. I think it's a B. I think you drop it down to B. Yeah.
It could be a B. Hey, go ahead.
All right, that man. Works. So listen, all right? Now it's heating up a little bit, and then we're going to get the very sharp decline. WWE 2K14, this was an amazing game, bro. I still remember getting home from school. This was it. To me, this is an S-tier game, at least for 2K. I feel like we haven't seen anything like WWE 2K14 since. We had the 30 years of WrestleMania. The gameplay was freaking amazing. They introduced at that point the catching finishers, I believe, for 2K14. Mm-hmm. The roster got even bigger, and online was even better. I had tons of fun with 2K14, and to me, that is my favorite childhood game and game of all time. I'm going to go with S tier. Now, Kenny, go ahead, my boy.
So, the reason I rated 2K13 so low at a D was because it did the unthinkable. It made me not buy the wrestling game the following year, where even though SmackDown versus Raw sometimes felt like it was repetitive, every year I bought those games and I was excited to play them. But when 2K14 came out, I think the Xbox One came out that same year. We had like Grand Theft Auto. We had a Killer Instinct, which I was really looking forward to. I was like, you know what? I'm not even going to bother because these games are all the same. Today, I regret that because I hear how fondly people look upon WWE 2K14, but I just didn't play it. So I cannot give this one a rating.
All right. Now, Kiro. Now, Kenny can't throw off the average of my vote now. So,
Kiro, go ahead. I won't do it. Not fair.
Because I'm a little less seasoned than Kenny, let's say. I wasn't yet sick of the WWE game, so I did buy 2K14. In fact, I reversed the cover, and I had Daniel Bryan on there. And
over the Rock. Man,
yeah, man. Over the Rock. I was a big mark back then.
I would have done the same thing with Cody Rhodes, but go ahead.
Yeah, maybe they'll do something like that this year. Dude, that game was insane. I mean, the biggest thing for me is defeat the streak. My complaint has always been that, like, The AI is just too easy. Legend, you play two matches and you figure it out and it's done. And unless you play online, the game never ever challenges you. But Undertaker, defeat the streak mode, challenged you.
Nuts.
Yeah. And like, it wasn't just a difficult match. Like, he reversed you a lot, sure, but he had special moves. He would like grab you right from the ground and just hit you with a choke slam and stuff, teleport. It was so good. Like, they need to bring it back this year, next year. I don't care. Just bring it back. For that mod alone, like, that made it up for me. I remember just playing a lot of Universe mode. Like, and it was obvious that 2K, not 2K, but Yuke's kind of knew that, okay, this is it for our PS3, Xbox 360 era. This is going to be our farewell letter. So they put everything in there. We had the Kratos finisher as well. I think we could do like moves from the corner now. That was the new thing. Kratos story was still in there. Community creations was much improved in comparison to last year's. Like, it was such a strong game where everything kind of came together. 30 years of WrestleMania was so well done too. Like, they actually put work in it. It wasn't like a throwaway mode. And you had so many unique wrestlers from the Attitude Era, from the 80s. So much was in this game. I just loved it. I just loved it. So,
100%
S-tier.
Go ahead, though.
Oh, S-tier. Ooh, okay.
S-tier. Now, Loaded, did you skip this one?
No, I did not.
All right, my boy, you came back at the right time.
So, I never owned the game, but my nephews at the time, this was like 2014, they brought the game over to the house. They brought their PS3 over.
Mm.
They brought it over to the house. So, I was like, you know, let me play it with them. I'm like, holy shit, this game is good. That was the last time I created my own character.
Oh,
was 2K14, and I just remember having a blast playing with them. It was a lot of fun. I never played online. I never played Beat the Streak or 30 Years of WrestleMania. I wish I did. I wish I had it myself. I had a lot of fun with it. So I'll give it an A tier.
Right.
It's a great game. The gameplay is great, by the way, too. So
this
was
great. Now, go ahead, UTB. Let us know, man.
Hey, this was another game where online really got taken to the next level. Like, oh man, this game right here, man, online and offline, man. Yeah, 30 years of WrestleMania, Beat the Streak. You had so many amazing match types that I don't know, we may could possibly get back with 2K24, but hey, it ain't gonna hit like 2K14.
Nothing will ever hit like 2K14.
Remember watching the custom stories from New Legacy on 14, like, man, those were the days, man. I would have to give that an S. SSS.
All right, we rocking with it. I think S is the general consensus, and I think this will probably be the last game that makes S. So
guys, this is why you gotta stick with it. I'm not one to ever give up, but I did give up after 2K13 for just 1 year.
In that game, you could do a 3-on-3 chamber match. I believe that was the last time you could do it.
2K, you listening?
Oh, you right. That's a great point.
That 3-on-3 chamber.
Yeah, I remember playing that match with my nephews over and over. That match type is so much fun. 3-on-3. That was the last time you could do it.
Yep, I agree. Well, so now, go ahead, Kiro.
It was 2K14. Now it's 2K24. So. You never know,
man. I've really got high hopes for this game, man. But listen, oh boy. All right. So, you guys remember when we saw those first next gen screenshots of WWE 2K15? You saw Randy Orton, you saw John Cena, and you said, "Holy word!" You know what I'm saying? This is gonna be the game right here. This is it. Because we were all thinking, at least I was thinking, 2K15 is going to have all the features 2K14 had. It's going to be even better because the graphics are going to be crazier. Mm-hmm. But boy, was we in for a surprise, man. WWE 2K15, I'm not going to put it in F or D because the graphic overhaul was simply amazing. Like, it was just great. Like, look at the way John Cena looks, bro. Like, that just looks nice. You know what I'm saying?
I remember that.
But I think that I got to put the game in C because of just how bare bones it was. They literally stripped everything out, and this is where I believe, and I got to disagree with Kenny, this is where the sharp decline came. After this game, wrestling games haven't been the same, in my opinion. We hope to turn that around with 24, but it just hasn't been the same, so I got to go with C for this game. Now, Kenny, go ahead, man.
I'm going to give 2K15 a B. I think taking that year off for 2K14 like refreshed me where I wanted to play a wrestling game again. And when I got into 2K15, I actually enjoyed it. I found myself going out and actually thinking, I can't wait to get home to play WWE 2K15. And I wasn't in that space for a long time before I played it. So I enjoyed 2K15. I know it was stripped down. A lot of features were removed that we still haven't gotten back, but I thought it was pretty good. So for the next gen, or the for the first next gen version of the 2K games, I'm going with a B.
Yep. And before we move on, I will say, I know Taco Kid just said it was better on old gen. I will 100% agree with you. It had all the match types, everything. It was like basically 2K14.5 at that point. But yes, I do agree. The old gen games were definitely better. Now, go ahead, load it.
2K15. Yeah. John Cena broke Kittle. He will be right back. Oh, he's
back. I'm back. I've been here the whole time.
Now, go ahead.
Dude, 2K15 is also my sleeper hit. I don't know why, but I really like it. Yeah, I agree completely. Like, it got gutted, and it lost all the game modes and all that. Like, even just some of the simple stuff that we give AW some slack for, or, like, crap for, basically. Like, why is this match type that is so simple to put in here, not here? But I just love how smooth the game is, man. Like, you could crawl to a pin. While you were crawling, you could jump and, like, double X handle people and break the pins. While you were on your knees, you can go for a pin. Like, all the animations flow together so smoothly. And, like, there was actually a different way of selling, too, in the game. Like, different animations. Like, people would maybe put their hands up while they're laying on their back, or they would, like, lay on their side.
Oh, yeah.
Those were
yeah.
taken out. Like, the connections, I don't know. Like, you could throw people to the ropes. And the way they would sell it would be cool. Like, nowadays, they just kind of move like this. But they would actually, like, interact with the ropes. There was actual physics there.
Yeah.
I'm really fond of it. I don't know. I spent a lot of time playing Universe Mode in that game. Insane amount of time, actually. Way too much than it ever deserved. But just because of that alone, man. And the Showcase Mode. Let's mention the Showcase Mode. Like, that was actually really good. You had, like, a lengthy, super long CM Punk and John Cena Showcase. Triple H and Shawn Michaels Showcase. And then you had the DLC, like Hollow Pain was absolutely badass. One more match was badass. We can forget about Ultimate Warrior, but hey, it was good, man. I mean, to me it was good. So I'm gonna put it at a B as well.
I agree.
Great soundtrack too.
Yeah. No, I agree that the showcase, I wish that they would go back to how 15 and the rest were till they started adding these real life cutscenes, bro. I could just go on YouTube for that. But yes, I will agree they stripped the game down, but their showcases were on point. They definitely took complete advantage of the Xbox One and PS4s at that time, for sure.
Absolutely.
And Loaded. Go ahead, my boy.
As someone who loved 2K14, I skipped out on this one. Even though Sting was a pre-order bonus, I was aware of that at the time. I still skipped it. I didn't care.
Was that 15?
Yeah, he was a pre-order bonus. I remember that, yeah.
Might be.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
All right, man. So, UTV, let us know, my boy.
Man, it's just like you were saying, like, you playing 2K14 and you're like, oh boy, I wonder what the next game is going to be like. This, like, just when you thought that wrestling games better. Could be dying, you're like, oh, 14, step in the right direction. Then you play 15, you're like, okay, what is this? So I spent the entirety of that year playing the 360 version, like, the Xbox One, the PS4 version, you know, this was so bad. True story. This was so bad. I didn't even want to look at this game. This game disgusts me. I took this game to GameStop. I was like, I don't even care what you give me. Just take the game. I don't care. Just kept playing that 360 version. So, yeah, I'll give this a C or a D. It's not going to be an A or a B for me. I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, for sure. So I think C would be the general consensus. The chat thinks it's C. Me and UTV thinks it's C.
But the chat says C or less, so I don't know if they're trying to say it's booty cheeks, but it's not. But yeah, I think C is fair.
No, I definitely don't think it was booty cheeks, because I played, like I said, bro, I logged hours into this game. Maybe it was young
me too.
But I logged hours, even though it was stripped down to the T. I personally, I really liked the game, but it was just stripped down. Like, that's just what it is. Now, 2K16. Okay. I logged a lot of hours into this game as well, but I can't remember so much about it. Seems very forgettable.
Well, I was going to say the same thing.
Yeah.
I do not. I bought 2K16. I played it, but I do not remember it.
I played it a lot. Now, 16 for me, I feel like this was how Kenny felt. And this was when I started to check out mentally. I had wrestling games for a while. So I think 16, man, I got to personally go with a C for that as well. Now, Kenny, do you have any input?
I think I got to go C as well because it left no impressions. I remember, again, I buy these things every year except 14, but I don't remember 16 at all. I just don't remember like the time I put into it.
Yeah. Kiro.
For me, this is way worse than 2K15. I played this game. I played two matches and everything felt like so freaking robotic now. All the smoothness was gone. It felt absolutely terrible. So I said, let me play the my career mode. And that was obviously also very bare bones. So all the problems I had with 2K15 were kind of in this game. Sure, we had more match types or whatever. But still, I had all the problems. And then the gameplay that I liked 2K15 for so much, that was also gone and restricted. Like, if you thought 2K14 to 2K15 made things slower, to me, it felt like 2K16 even, like, tripled that. And I don't know. At the time, I guess I was fed up with it. I played 2K15 a whole lot the past year. Like, I literally just remember deleting the game, and I never opened it until like 5-6 years until I was going to do like a YouTube series on it. So I don't know why, but I really didn't like this game. It just was not hitting for me. They changed it up next, like in the following years, and made it more smoother and a little faster. But man, 2K16, I just don't like it. I think it brought the limited reversals as well. Mm-hmm. Correct me if I'm wrong. I don't. Yeah, D.
All right. D, all right, load it. Let us know.
I only played this game once at a friend's house. I played one match. It didn't leave a good first impression on me. So I agree with Kiro, D.
Okay. And UTV, we got two C's and two D's. Pause. But go ahead.
this game, just like 2K15, just, man, did not leave a good impression. Another year that I spent playing the 360 version, but the thing is, the 360 version wasn't really that amazing either. It was just, I didn't really like it. This game was just a blur. I don't remember much improvements. I mean, the presentation, I guess you can say, more stuff in the creation suite, but it wasn't, you know, wasn't that big of a difference. It wasn't, you know, that many changes. You could put it in a C, D, either one. It's up to you.
CD's nuts.
You got to pick one though, because it's a tie right now, my boy. You got to pick one.
You had to pick.
I'll pick D, bro. I remember that Arnold Schwarzenegger pre-order bonus too. Like, man, it was.
Oh awesome. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So D it is, man. All right. So
I'll be back.
All right. So now that we got that out the way, we're down to our remaining six games. And WWE 2K17. I remember playing this because somebody game shared the game to me, but this was actually my first WWE game that I physically did not buy or ask my parents to buy. At that point, since like I first played, what?
2012,
since 2010, my boy, but 7 years is good enough, bro.
Yeah, it's a good streak. It's a good streak.
So 7 years, I was buying a game, and 2K17. I remember the marketing for this game was backstage area, right? If I'm not mistaken.
Oh, man.
Well, Goldberg was a pre-order bonus.
Yeah, yes. That's what I remember.
And I remember that there was like a bigger backstage area. Like I said, I played the game. I played it for a good month or two, but I dropped it. I would probably have to put this game in C again. So, Kenny, go ahead.
So 2K17 is one I do remember I enjoyed a lot. This is another one, just the vibe and aesthetic, like from the box art and everything, the commercials, the marketing rollout. I loved everything about how they actually got it to us, but these games blend together so much at this point, it's hard to remember anything specific on it, but I do remember I really enjoyed 2K17, so I'm going to put this one at a B.
Hero, so we got a C and a B, go ahead.
I mean, this. I remember the graphics of this game looking worse than like the PS2 era, honestly. Like, it was weird. Every Laressa looked like Play-Doh, or like as if they've been stung by like 100 bees. They were so bloated. But it was better than 2K16 as far as gameplay goes and everything goes. I don't know if it had like a showcase mode. It might have skipped it. I really don't remember. But I do remember that I went back and actually played this game legit. Like, I skipped 2K16. I did not play for an entire year. So that definitely helped a lot. But yeah, a whole lot of time spent in universe mode. You know what? Like I said, it was better. The gameplay got a little better. Plus, I think it was the first year ever we got AJ Styles. That was a big thing for me, too. Like, that's why I came back as well. Just wanted to see how it would play. 2K17, so I'm going to say it's better than 16. I put 16 at D, so I'll put this at C.
Okay. And let's see here. So it does have a showcase, but it was DLC. Just so you are aware. Okay. So, yep. So.
Oh, they held the showcase back as DLC?
Yep, they did.
Yeah, I didn't buy DLC back then, so I would have never even touched it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It looked honestly like it was mid.
I'm going to bump down to a C because of that.
But yeah. Now, Loaded. Go ahead, my boy. Let us know.
This is the first 2K game this was my first 2K game that I purchased. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I think the marketing just reeled me in because I'm like, oh, Goldberg's a pre-order bonus?
Yeah.
Check this out. Maybe I'll play it. So I ended up pre-ordering it just to get Goldberg. I put a lot of hours into online, though. I didn't really play the other game modes, but I remember putting so many hours online and meeting so many people there. The gameplay was fun. So I'm going to give it a C.
Okay. All right. So we got C's, a lot of C's. And going ahead, UTV, and let us know, man.
Still not one of my favorites, but I did play it a little bit more than 16, so I guess put it in C.
Okay, so C. I think we can all agree on C then. So 2K17 will be in C. Oh, boy. All right, so WWE 2K18. I played this game, but I also skipped it as well at the same time. It was game share to me. I did not buy this game.
Huh.
And I'm going to be honest, this is all a blur to me. I don't remember 2K18 at all. It's tough to grade, but if I had to grade it, I would probably keep it at C as well. Kenny, go ahead.
Yeah, this is another one that I bought and I just don't remember it at all. So, they all blend together pretty much the same as 17, but I'm going to go C just because I don't remember this one, where I do remember a lot about 17.
Agreed.
Man. From 2000, WWE 12 to WWE 19, I was a huge universe mode guy, and this game stands out because I did not, like, after 2K15, I stopped playing and I just let the match simulate itself, and this was so nice. The gameplay, I think, is actually better here. The simulation aspect especially is way better than even 2K19. I thought the pacing of the matches were messed up there. The AI was so cool. They would hit so many cool combinations. Realistic scenarios would happen. They would crawl. They would hang on to the ropes. Like, I had some of the most fun ever watching AI matches. I did a match between Edge and Christian. It was the WrestleMania main event. Christian, like, barely beat Shawn Michaels to qualify. It was like, and all the matches were just banger after banger. And not just one-on-one matches, but, like, even when I did a tag team match, just a random tag team match, like, AI would put on bangers. And I don't know. I had so much fun memories. But the game itself, it's ass because, like, it didn't even have showcase mode, not even as DLC at this point. Like, they said, we're going to focus on the gameplay, the universe mode, and all that stuff, though. We're not doing showcase for this year, which was an absolute lie. They did nothing on universe, but the gameplay itself was so good. So, just because of that, for me, this game is going to be a B.
Okay. Loaded.
That's surprising to hear that you saying the gameplay was good. I was not a big fan of the gameplay. They slowed it down. I thought 2K17's gameplay was better. Yeah. And I played Universe Mode for a little bit. I believe it was the first time I played Universe Mode. I'm not a big fan of it at all.
Mm-hmm.
This was the first time they brought back Match Creator in 2K18.
I think so.
Last time they had it was 2K14. So that was a good addition. But not a fan of the gameplay. So I'll give it a C.
Okay. And UTV, let us know, man.
Yeah, a little bit of the same. Not really a fan. Mm-mm-mm. And please, for those of y'all in chat, please, I'm begging you, do not get this game on the Nintendo Switch. Please.
I saw somebody in the chat mention that.
Irvin, oh, my God.
The Brew.
All right. So I guess the general consensus here is C for WWE 2K18. They went on, like, boy, they went on the worst, like, from 15 all the way up, and now we're at 19. So 19, 19 situation, not that it was as good as 14, but it sort of reminds me of how we all felt, okay, this is going in a good direction, because 19 mm-hmm. picked it up and ramped it up and the game felt good. I almost skipped 19 and I'm glad I got to play it. And I actually ended up buying it for PC because I noticed that they delayed it another year or something like that happened at that point where 20 wasn't good, but we'll get to that. Now, 19, I had a lot of fun with it. I'm going to put this in a B, in my opinion. Kenny, go ahead.
19, they kind of tightened up all of the bolts and they made that game, it made it fun. Like you said, this was... If you liked 14, everything else was kind of mid since then. I thought 19 was actually really good. So being at the fact that I did like this game, I was actually trying to go through and get all the achievements in it. That's how I know if I like something, because I want to find something to do. So I'm going to go with an A for 19. I thought that one was really good.
Yeah, that's acceptable for sure. Kira, go ahead. Let us know.
Come on. This game had the big head mode. Yeah. It had I think... the best my career in a long while, where your character was actually competent and he did cool stuff, the Bray Wyatt stuff, the multiverse stuff, the series storylines was good. I still remember the storyline with the Miz and Maryse. You get to create your like own title, like the story mode, honestly better than anything 2K has put up ever since. So I really like that they hit that, you know, very nicely. Your mode was good. You could create all the arenas so with so much detail. I mean, again, the community creations kind of popped off. It was kind of sort of like a 2K14 situation where they had a vision and they finally executed it after so many years. Like this was the game where they kind of put everything in. And like before this moment, with 17, 18, I was so hopeless. Like, okay, these games are going to be done. But like 2K was definitely, 19 was definitely a step in the right direction. It was fun, man. They introduced paybacks and stuff like that. I loved it. I loved playing it. I loved simulating it. I will put this at an A too.
Okay. Now, Loaded, did you play this game?
I did. Yeah, this was, I believe, Uke's last WWE game. So they tried to make it great under 2K, but, you know, 2K doesn't want to put all their eggs in one basket. You know, they like to save certain features for the next game. Yuke's tried to make a great game, and it was a great game. I enjoyed it. The gameplay was fun. They had very cool animations. I spent most of my time online and with community creations, so I give it an A. Very enjoyable game.
All right, and UTV, let us know, man. How do you feel about WWE 2K19?
This game definitely was 2K's last piece of good work. It really was. And I would say my biggest complaints were the reversal limits and the fact that there were no lobbies online. I remember like it was yesterday, for the most part, I would have to go to the Xbox communities page and be like, hey, anybody want to play? Pause.
Yeah.
Outside of that, I did enjoy it. Like, you see people to this day saying, oh man, we need this from 2K19 when it comes to the creation suite. Like, 2K19, it was that game. I'll give it a I'll give it a B.
B, okay. So we have a lot of A's. So we're just gonna go ahead and put that game in A, and I'm not mad at it.
Yeah, the chat lost it in at A, 73%. So
I'm not mad at it. That was a great WWE game. And that was great. Now, boys, this is basically like 2K14 to 2K15. We gotta talk about WWE 2K20. And I'm not going to lie, I am very, very happy that I skipped this game. I got to play it because of my brother, but I skipped this game. I did not buy it. I had no intentions on buying this game. And boy, oh boy, I'm glad I did, because to me, this is butt cheeks. Go ahead, Kenny.
So, as I said, I buy these games every year. 2K20 is another one that I did not buy but up front, because I saw everybody like doing the whole ref gift things. I was like, oh man, I'm not buying this game, it's too buggy or whatever. But Xbox did like a sale in the store where it was like $10 or something, so I said, you know what, I'll get it, you know, I want to play it. So I got it and I played it, and I really actually enjoyed it. It had the bugs and stuff, but it didn't, like, I already knew they were there. It was only $10, so I didn't let it bother me. I actually finished everything in the game, and I tried to get the achievements in it as well. So I think 2K20 gets a lot of hate, and rightfully so, because the game was broken. But when it comes to the actual gameplay, it was just as good as 2019. So I got to go D because of the bugs and stuff, but I think if the bugs weren't there, then the game would have been pretty good.
Word. Okay. Kiro, go ahead.
I disagree, because WWE 2K20 is the mutated child of WWE. No, the exact opposite. Basically, 2K20 had worse graphics. The consistency wasn't there with the art direction.
Have we seen how The Rock looks? Sorry to cut you off.
Yeah, I mean, that's like an iconic shot right there all by itself. And then you had all the bugs. If you ignore them, let's go to the story mode. The story mode basically made you, excuse my French, when you played as the male superstar, a cuck. Basically, and the story was nonsensical. It didn't mean anything. It was annoying. It was stupid as hell. It was really bad. It was almost as bad as AEW booking, and it had Samoa Joe. Coincidentally, so life is kind of funny like that.
You gotta relax.
Samoa Joe literally had a bionic arm, Kenny, and they
You said AEW booking what?
Yeah. Anyway,
there we go.
You gotta relax.
Universe mode also was a buggy ass mess, so that's why I stopped playing Universe mode after so many years as well. In this game, it just did nothing right. Let's go to the DLC. It was like, you get to have tentacles. Oh, Alexa with like futuristic stuff. Like, okay, great. Thank you so much. No. 2K20 was so close to being ass cheeks, but because it again has the older game's DNA, which is 2K19, I'm gonna put it at F. But it was a disgrace. It was an insult. It should not have happened.
All right. And now, Loaded, let us know, man.
Hold on. Did they take away Match Creator?
I can't remember.
It was still there.
It was still there? Yeah. I'll still give it butt cheeks. I never played it.
All right, UTV, go ahead.
Ooh, wait, when I tell you this game right here, you want to talk about a rant. This game made me lose my mind, bro. This game out of the whole entire 2K series was the worst. This game makes AEW Fight Forever look like the perfect game. That's how bad this game was. Like Kido was saying with the DLC, you had all this futuristic cyborg stuff. You had you fighting in like a lava pit and all this. It was just like unnecessary stuff. Just terrible. You go online, it's like, all right, better go ahead and get into some action. Better get into a match. Crash. Oh, let me go and create somebody. Oh, hold up. You attach one move to your superstar. Oh, let me save it before it crashes. It was so buggy. You go back to the creation suite. I'm looking at Becky Lynch. She's looking like she just went one-on-one with Jason Voorhees. It was just terrible all around. Put this... No. It doesn't even deserve a butt cheeks. What is below butt cheeks? Add a new category for this game, please.
I don't want to know what's below butt cheeks. Go ahead.
This game is balls.
All right. So...
All right, 91% of the chat says butt cheeks. So, yeah, 2K20 was booty cheeks, I guess.
All right.
But I still give it a D. I don't think the gameplay was too bad.
Yeah, it was not.
Oh, Assassin's Creed Unity was booty cheeks.
But now, WWE 2K22. I'm not going to lie, this was the first game I purchased in a while initially that I was actually excited for and keeping up with the marketing. I knew they took a year off that they needed desperately.
Yeah.
Like 2 years off, right?
They took
almost,
yeah, because then they delayed it from that October window to March. So it was almost 2 years. 22, I'm not going to lie, I know a lot of people feel some type of way about this game, but I actually enjoy 22. I love the graphics. The graphics look freaking insane. They were out of this world. When you first saw Brock Lesnar's entrance in WWE 2K22, it looked crazy. The gameplay, I still disagree with some of the things that are going on now, but it just felt much better than what 20 felt like. And I hadn't played a game in so long for WWE 2K, so it was definitely a nice, just refreshing game. So for 22... I would put that in B. Now, Kenny, go ahead.
All right, Brian, could you scroll up a bit so they could see what's in the S tier category?
Oh, yeah.
For the people who are just coming in.
Go ahead.
All right, so for 2K22, personally, in my opinion, I don't think 2K22 was better than 2K19. The whole new engine thing, it's kind of been a bit off to me. So Rey Mysterio being the cover star didn't hit for me. I didn't like the aesthetic. I'm going D for 2K22.
Okay. D, that's a K.
Well, I was expecting it to hit like a lot harder than it did with them taking that year off, but I got in, played a few times, and never played again. I just really didn't like 2K22 at all.
Feel you. Kiro, go ahead, my boy. Let us know.
I mean, this game felt to me like, again, one of those games that was a step in the right direction, but in some aspects, and then it was a step in the wrong direction in some aspects. Now, it was easily better than 2K20, but I mean, creating a better game than 2K20 isn't all that challenging when you think about it. But I gotta agree with Kenny. 2K19, I still like it better. Like, overall, in every single aspect, I think 2K19 was a better game than 2K22, but I would not give it a D. I would say, I would put it over games like 2K15, 17, and 18, so it'd be a B for me.
Yep, same here. Loaded, go ahead, my boy.
I prefer 2K19. There was nothing really special about this game. They just changed the gameplay. So, they're fighting like fighters. You're blocking now, you're dodging. this was the first time they introduced it, so I wasn't a big fan of it. They didn't add new match types at all in this game. So same old BS. So, I give it a D.
Okay, D. All right, and UTV, let us know, man.
Yeah, I definitely prefer 2K19. Like, oh, man. Oh, man, oh, man. Like, I guess you could say it was better than 2K20. Almost anything's better than 2K20. That game was so bad. You know, we spent, like, what, 2 to 3 years playing 19? You know, with 2K22, they added the blocking, the dodging and all that. I'm like, I've said it a million times and I'm going to keep on saying it. Are you trying to make this franchise into a fighting game or keep it as a wrestling game? Like, it was just, I don't know, man. I was not feeling it. I'll give it a D, man.
All right, so we have
three D's,
and
chat gave it a B.
So we have three B's and three D's. So do we put this game in C?
It's at the back end of C.
Yep.
All right,
y'all. So now we have made it to the last game, and it is WWE.
Don't you got a secret game on the list that we're gonna talk about after this one?
Oh yeah, I do have a secret game on the list, my boy. We're about to talk about that soon. But WWE 2K23. Oh boy. Okay. So I'm not going to lie. I actually enjoyed this game. I played it all the way till September. And I still load it up sometimes. I will say that modding is what keeps this game going for me. And 23, I'm not crazy about the gameplay just like 22, but I enjoyed a lot of the universe mode cutscenes that they added and things like that. I just wish that the showcase would be better improved and put more effort into it. But 23, I would probably have to go with a B for 23. Now, Kenny, go ahead, my boy. Let us know.
All right. So 2K23, I do like the aesthetic a lot more than 2K22. And I don't know if y'all, but the aesthetic is really important to me in all of these wrestling games. Title menu and everything like that. But 2K23 was a step in the right direction, but not all the way there yet. The community creations is amazing. For one, I could pretty much search for anybody I want and I can find them. These people are creating AEW stars to look just like them, and WWE did really good with making the created wrestlers not look like NPCs, like so far off from the other wrestlers in the game. My Rise is a mess, still terrible. They need to go ahead and fix that. They need to take off the fat and make that mode a lot better. Give us a better storyline. The lock stuff was, I guess, supposed to be cute, but it was stupid. Showcase mode, we all have the same issues with showcase mode, with them using real life footage instead of using footage from the actual game, like creating those cinematics to recreate those moments. So there's a lot wrong here, but again, they did get some of the things right. As far as the actual gameplay, I don't like the reversal system. I don't like the combo system. I don't like the dodging stuff. I want them to make it feel like a wrestling game. Now, I know I thought D was kind of harsh for 2K22, but seeing that so many other people agree with that, I guess it's not. But 2K23 was an improvement, but it's not a B. That's why I can't put 2K22 at a C. So I'm going to go C for 2K23, and I'm just hoping 2K24 is at least a B, and I'll see some improvement, and I'll be happy with that game.
Agreed. Now, Kiro, let us know.
Wow, okay. I think, just like Kenny said, this game is better than 2K22. But not so much that I would put it on another tier. It's the same tier. It'd just like be more than 2K22.
Agreed.
Because that was a bit of an improvement, sure. The creative stuff, us being able to use PNGs, I think wasn't that back in 2K22 anyways. I don't know. But like this year really just felt like, oh, we got war games. Cool. And that was pretty much it. No improvement to my rise. Sure, there were some little changes. And I think I appreciate the direction it has taken. It's definitely better than 2K22's, but like still tons of room for improvement. I don't know. I feel like what I wanted to see out of 2K23 is what we're going to see out of 2K24. So this game was kind of like in a limbo. It didn't really do much, but it didn't do anything else to offend either. So... Mm-hmm. What did I give 2K22? I don't remember.
I think you gave it a B.
I'll give this one a B as well, but just like behind 2K22.
Okay. Loaded. Let us know.
2K23. Nothing really changed. I mean, it's just really the same as 22. You just got war games. That's pretty much it. And you can't play it online. You play it online, you're back to the lobby, my boy. You're back to the lobby. Stun meter, I hate it. I hate the dodging, hate the blocking. The only thing carrying 23 now is the community creations. From time to time I play it, and I'm downloading AEW Superstars, and I'm playing exhibition mode. That's about it. So I'm just sitting here waiting until 2K24. Let's see what they do.
Let's do it.
So this one, I give it a D. Actually, no, I'll be generous. I'll give it a C.
I think D is fair too, but yeah.
All right.
See, he is generous. I was generous too.
Yeah. All right. So, UTV, let me know, man.
Yeah, I definitely agree, especially as an online player. I don't know how many times I've been in some heated matches, and next thing you know, I'm back at the main menu. Like, it is so crazy how bad these servers are. It's an online player's nightmare. They didn't really add anything new, you know, besides war games. You know, all the offline modes, you know, they've pretty much play the same, look the same. And the fact that you have to... Okay, so you know how you purchase the most expensive edition, whatever. You do all that. You think you're going to unlock everything. Oh, no. You have to go play Showcase. Like,
yeah,
it's just, man.
That sucks.
It's too much. But hopefully with 2K24, they learn from their mistakes. Hopefully. And I will give it, I guess, a little bit of an edge over 22, because I will admit, I tried to go back to that and play online before it got shut down, and it was unbearable. I couldn't do it. But so, yeah, I'll give it a C.
All right. So I think...
It's a pretty solid C.
I know chat likes A, but...
Y'all likes A.
Yeah, but I think that... There were so many C's thrown around that we might have to leave it in C. I don't think it was a tier better than 22. I'm not going to lie.
Isn't it the highest rated 2K game, apparently?
You know why.
I mean, I believe it, but they probably pay for that rating.
Exactly. All the discounts they had, 67% off, 90% off, a discount every single week.
It's the highest rated 2K game. I'm like, better than 2K19? I don't know.
All right. So, I'm actually happy with this list. Would you guys
We got to rearrange those C's.
Yes.
Because
WWF
Attitude and Warzone got to go to the back. Let's make sure everything is lined up where we think it should be in each tier.
Right. All right. So do you guys think this is good? SmackDown, I think this is good. The S tier, right?
I think S is good.
All right. Yeah. A, do you guys believe that All-Stars is the best A tier game?
We can put it a bit down.
Maybe 2K19 is the best A tier game. Unless we go SmackDown versus Raw.
I think put it after 10.
Oh, yes. I forgot 10 was there. 10 is number one to me.
Which I want to do with 10.
Y'all voted 11 over 10. So, yeah.
I choose 11 over 10.
All Stars. All right.
So that's good.
How about Shut Your Mouth?
Shut Your Mouth has got to be. I would say that could probably go right maybe right there with All Stars. Maybe
right here? I would put it over All Stars. Right, yeah. Yeah. All right.
How about is this 06?
06.
06 probably for me. It goes to the back.
How about 07? Right by All Stars or before?
I would put SmackDown versus Raw with Vince on the front, the first one in front of those.
Yeah, exactly.
I would put Day of Reckoning in front of 06.
Mm-hmm. Same. Yeah, I think so too.
All right, 06. All right. And All right, so A is good.
A is good for me.
All right, how about B?
I think B is good for me.
I agree as well. How about you guys? B? All right. C, I think we got some. Yeah, this one got to get tweaked.
Got some work to do.
All right, so.
I'd say just put, which one of the SmackDown or the WWE 2K games did y'all like the best? So 2K23 probably goes up front.
Yeah.
All right. I guess you can put 22 behind here. You said Immortals was bad, right? Or it wasn't?
You could put it even down.
Yeah, you could even put 2K22 down. I could.
Oh, leave it back here?
You could put it back there. You could put it as a D, either one, that game.
Put Immortals as D because it's a phone game. Like it's
put Attitude and Warzone to the back, all the way to the back.
Oh, yeah.
In front of Immortals, though.
All right.
All right. That too.
This, move it back.
It was worse than Attitude.
How about just bring it serious. Is this good here?
I say put them behind the 2K games. Unless y'all want to take them back further.
No, this is good. I think.
Or should they be in front of the 2K games? What are you? Again, these are two I didn't play.
I think they should be in front of the 2K games, bro. For sure.
If UTV played them and he says in front, then let's leave them in the front.
All right. So I think this is it right here for C. All right. And D, we have.
Put Raw 2 in the bike.
Yeah.
Oh, no, wait a minute. 2008 was bad.
No, it's not
bad, but it was not Raw 2 bad.
Yeah, it's not Raw 2 bad.
Close.
I think 16 is
not in the front of the D's.
I think 16 is the best D tier game, though, in my opinion.
Yeah, I think that's pretty good.
All right, and I think butt cheeks, that don't really matter unless y'all want to put how butt cheeks game is. But
they all booty cheeks, so they booty
cheeks. Yeah.
All right, and we got one game left.
Yes, we do have one game left, fellas.
All right, Stuart, what is that game, Ryan? Dun dun dun. Dun dun dun.
I can probably already guess what this game is. I just got a feeling.
Let's see.
Hold on. Give me one sec, y'all.
Hold on, y'all. I cannot Ryan even tell. A mystery game coming up.
What are we missing? Oh, screen's gone.
We're getting the tears ready.
A mystery game, huh?
Mystery game. Hold on, man. Cause I had this ready, but for some reason it's giving me a lot of trouble.
We got Brian driving. We got Brian driving.
Ironic.
Drive, pal.
There's some bumps on the road, but we'll get there.
You know what? All
right, y'all.
You ready?
Got it? We are ready, fellas.
As soon as you put it up, the poll's going up.
Oh, baby.
AEW Fight Forever.
I knew it. AEW
Fight Forever. Now, we're talking about ranking the wrestling games. I think this one definitely has to be on the list because we were only looking at WWE games so far, but AEW can definitely stand in there with some of these games. I don't know if TNA could or not because I skipped that one, but I think we got to give AEW a shout out. So, AEW Fight Forever, where would we put this game? I didn't mean to take the wheel, Brian, but you go ahead and go first.
No, you're good. It's so conflicting because the gameplay is good. The roster's ass. Sorry, I know we gotta keep it a bit.
No, you're good. I think that one's fine.
Yeah, the roster's not good. The modes, there are no modes.
He's stuff, right?
We got modes.
I can't put this in the same tier as 2K22, even though it wasn't good.
Create a wrestler is bad, terrible.
I gotta go with D. For AEW Fight Forever. The gameplay was good, but man, has it struggled with replayability and me getting on the Game Pass the first month. So, Kenny, go ahead, take it away, my boy.
All right, so for me, you made a lot of good points. It did have Road to Elite, so I'm glad it did have some type of story mode in there with them just not bypassing it all the way. But the roster's bad. There's really no game mode. You got some mini games in there. Creator Wrestler is bad, but the gameplay, I think, is where it shines. So, even though it's bare bones, I see the foundation, and I wouldn't give it a failing grade. I'm going to go 70. I got to give it a C. Okay. Bottom level C, but I give it a C.
All right, Kiro.
First of all, shout out to games like Fire Pro or like King of Coliseum or like a whole bunch of other wrestling games. We would like to mention them, but obviously that would be like 5 hours. As far as AEW, you know, if this game had like a universe mode, maybe a MyGM mode, maybe even some better storyline mode than Road to Elite, it could have went up to B easily. It could have gone up to A with the gameplay it has, assuming the gameplay is also fixed. But it doesn't have any of those. It doesn't have a creation mode either. So the great gameplay will only carry us so far for me. I'm stuck between a D and a C. I would say two things. I'm going to say AEW is also, just because of how strong the gameplay is, because I went back to it to capture some footage and still had so much fun, man. You're like, there is something there. So I'm going to say it's a C. Also, let's bring down Immortals to D, man.
Okay, let's get it done. Everybody Immortals, agree with that?
D? Oh, you lost the spot. Yeah, I didn't play Immortals.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
All right, perfect. And Loaded.
Yeah, man. So I think the gameplay is great. Obviously, the game lacks content. The game is fun for about a week, then you're bored of it. Online is terrible. People are using cheesy-ass tactics to win matches now. Still to this day, people still play online. Very few. But they're still using cheap-ass tactics to win, and I can't stand it. All you could ever find is like one-on-one matches. Beat the Elite's terrible. Stadium Stampede is boring. It was fun at first for like a week, and then I got bored of that. Road to Elite, I never played it, so it's tough because they're gonna add more content to the game, but for right now, I'll give it a C.
All right. UTV, let us know.
Oh boy, I can go on with this game for hours on hours on hours, days on days, but hey, but the main thing holding this game together is definitely the gameplay. Like, in my honest opinion, like, I enjoy Fight Forever's gameplay. This is a hot take, but I enjoy Fight Forever's gameplay more than WWE 2K15 all the way up to now with 23. Like, that gameplay is beautiful.
I agree.
It's beautiful.
Me too.
But yeah, it's just that, where's the content? You know, we call this a live service game, but there's no live service. The most we're getting is, you know, we're getting little things here and there for Stadium Stampede. Oh, you want a mini game? You want some soundtracks? Oh, you want a new model? It's not new. It's outdated by like, what, 4, 5, 6 months? Mm-hmm. You know, you just got to add stuff to this game and let it grow. Yeah. But it's up to them. It's up to them. And I've seen a lot of comparisons. You'd be like, oh, well, Fortnite this. But I mean, the difference is, although Fortnite may be overpriced with their store, at least they're adding stuff to it. At least the community is being fed over there. You look at us, you look at our Steam, you look at our Steam charts, we only have 7 live players right now. Let that sink in, WGC. Do you know how depressing that is? 7 players. So yeah, I mean, we'll see what happens. The game just got put up. Hey, we'll see what happens. The game just got put up on Xbox free to play day. So we'll see what happens next.
All right.
And I would give it a C.
All right.
Strong C, I guess.
So I think the general consensus is C, but I believe that it's probably one of the worst from C. What do you guys think?
I would put it in front of Attitude and Warzone.
Okay.
Yeah, at least.
Personally, I would put it in front of 2K22 as well, but I don't know.
I'm not going to lie, that don't sit right with me, bro, but it's just the lack of content. That's all it is. It's not
lack of content really hurts it. So
yeah, talking about gameplay. It's more like we talking about 22 at Universe Showcase, even though it was half-assed. Then you got a couple other modes in there, MyGM, My Faction, even though My Faction is another money thing, but I'm just saying it just has content compared to
and
AEW.
Each and every single one of them was better than Beat the Elite, so I think 2K22 can stay there.
Yeah.
And mini games.
So This is the official list. I can go in ahead and save it. It
will scroll up a little bit for S tier, so make sure everybody can see it.
Let me make sure that everybody could see
This is the official list. Does everybody, are we going to lock it in?
What do you think, Kenny?
If you are on Twitter, make sure to go on ahead, follow our page. We're going to stay active on Off the Top YT. Y'all make sure to go follow that page on Twitter, man, and we're going to keep posting. Every time we go live, you'll get the notification. Every time one of us posts a video on our personal channels or on this channel, it'll be on there as well. So just make sure that you guys stay tuned to that X page as well.